say it. It's finally Friday. It's okay. We made it. You did it. Well done. Thank you so much for choosing to be with us. And being a Friday, you know what that means. It's time for us to entertain you, coast you into the weekend. Good morning,
definitely.
Friend.
Morning, G-Man. I know for a lot of people it was a short week because of Easter Monday. We also had the schools going back. So yes, we are all grateful for a short week. Now listen, we've got lots of sporting action happening, from gearing up to rugby and cricket action to shining the spotlight on elevating the art scene in South African townships. We've got it all covered for you today.
The absolute plug-in, and then of course it's the weekend before Eid, and then a lifestyle content creator, absolutely amazing, Raiza Albertus Makuse is here to share her top table setting tips. Just take a look at that. We will inspire you to create that in your beautiful space, and how to adorn your house, your beautiful flowers from Woolies as well. Got some great inspiration there. We've got you covered.
We've definitely got you covered. And then, of course, we need entertainment. It is a Friday and it's coming to you from Johannesburg. We have the mouthful. It's Skills, it's Sykes, it's Lebo the Great, Talk Music, as well as Pushkin, who's ready to perform and entertain us on this Friday.
Because it is a Friday, lest we forget. We're probably going to say it every time we see you. It's a Friday. We made it and we got you for the next 3 hours. We're going to have a blast and we're also going to start that conversation. So let's start that conversation right now and say a very good morning to Zanele. How are you doing, sister?
Morning. Good morning, my beautiful Cape Town family. It is your Feel Good Breakfast show, and we're coming to you live from the Samsung showroom at Design Quarter in Johannesburg. As you can see, I've got my weekend hair on, honey, because the weekend is in the building, and you've chosen the right place to start it off on the perfect note. So, yes, we're going to be having a whole lot of fun. You heard about Inkomo Yanamhlanje from my colleagues, but we also always want to hear from you on the social media streets. So let's take a look at the Good Morning Post. Today, we know that there is a whole lot of hosting that's going to be happening all around the country, trying to soak in that last bit of summer, yeah? So we want to hear from you all in the name of when your family hosts, my friend. Which one are you? Are you the person who makes the food? Are you the one who cleans up afterwards? Maybe you're the one who sets the table. Where do you fall in? Can I tell you mine? I'm none of the above. I'm the person who likes to make sure that the atmosphere, it looks pretty. So I like to sit and look pretty. And then I'll eat the food for you and I'll go home. Thank you very much. But that's me. What do you do? Use the hashtag Espresso Show and also send us those voice notes, 063-408-8863. We got a whole lot coming up. So let's get to business real quick. The beautiful Zoe is standing by with the news headlines.
Thank you, Zanele. Well, let's take a look at your local news. The former Speaker of the National Assembly, Nosa Siwe Mapisa Nqakula, was granted bail of 50,000 rand in Pretoria's Magistrates Court yesterday. Mapisa Nqakula faces 12 charges of corruption and one of money laundering related to allegations that she received millions of rand for favours from a contractor when she was Minister of Defence. She resigned as Speaker and MP on Wednesday and handed herself over to the police yesterday morning. She also had to surrender her passport and is not allowed to contact witnesses. The case was adjourned until the 4th of June. And political parties and independent candidates contesting the 2024 national and provincial elections have signed the Independent Electoral Commission's Code of Conduct, committing to abide by the set of rules that are meant to ensure for free and fair elections. The general elections will be held on the 29th of May to elect a new National Assembly, as well as the provincial legislature in each province. This will be the seventh general election since the end of the apartheid era in 1994. In total, 325 political parties will be taking part. We now move to news abroad. Somalia has expelled the Ethiopian ambassador. It has accused Ethiopia of infringing on its sovereignty and internal affairs and recalled the ambassador from Ethiopia. Tension has recently increased due to a controversial agreement between Ethiopia and Somaliland, according to which Ethiopia obtains access to Somaliland's seaports for military and commercial purposes. In return, Ethiopia recognizes Somaliland as an independent state. Somaliland broke away from Somalia some 30 years ago, but it isn't internationally recognized as an independent state. Somalia rejected the agreement and accused Ethiopia of violating its sovereignty. And the Secretary of the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, NATO, Jens Stoltenberg, has stressed Europe and North America's interdependence. The alliance, consisting of 32 countries, celebrated its 75th anniversary in Brussels yesterday. Stoltenberg says Europe relies on America as its security, and the US needs its European allies for their world-class militaries, information networks, and diplomatic influence. Finland and Sweden renounced their neutrality when Russia invaded Ukraine. Norway's Minister of Foreign Affairs, Espen Aid, says NATO has never been as important as at present. And we bring it back home. The Western Cape bids farewell to summer with a thriving tourism industry as Provincial Minister of Finance and Economic Opportunities, Merel Wagner, reports significant growth. International arrivals at Cape Town International Airport from January to February exceeded 200,000, surpassing the 2019 figures and setting a five-year record. Visitor numbers at key attractions across the province have risen by 20% year on year, signalling positive economic impact through job creation. The UK, Germany, the USA, Netherlands and France top the overseas air market to Cape Town, and Namibia and Zimbabwe lead from the rest of Africa. Data from SA Tourism reveals that every 100 international visitors generate some 2.1 million rand in direct tourist spend. Well, that's where I leave those headlines. Let's take a first look at your sport.
Understandably, football dominating our news this morning when it comes to the sport, because it's that end of the season. Let's start right there. In fact, Liverpool surging back to the top of the Premier League standings with a gritty 3-1 victory over a very gritty Sheffield United. Darwin Núñez and Connor Bradley exchanging early goals before as well. Just on the money, a late goal there securing the win ultimately, as Liverpool now sit 2 points clear of second place Arsenal in what is going to be an intense title race, with just 8 games remaining for each contender, and Man City breathing hard down their neck. Now, of course, a little bit lower down the table, things just as thrilling. And yeah, forget about the Fergie Five. Chelsea used all 101 minutes to orchestrate a remarkable 4-3 triumph over Manchester United and a sensational winner in stoppage time. Where was the red defence? So this crushing defeat leaves United languishing 11 points on the table, now reigniting their European ambitions after a roller coaster season under Pochettino. Now let's turn to tennis and some good news. The Women's Tennis Association has now confirmed that Saudi Arabia will host the WTA finals for the next 3 editions. That's from this year, 2024 to 2026. Now the season-ending tournament will take place in the capital city of Riyadh, and with the first edition scheduled from the 2nd to the 9th of November this year. The deal comes after months of speculation and criticism, but the WTA has now expressed excitement about bringing a women's tournament of this magnitude to that part of the world. And the agreement also includes a significant increase in prize money, with a record $15.25 million offered for this year's tournament. Finally addressing that pay gap. Now let's turn to tennis, and Rafa Nadal sadly has had to withdraw from the upcoming Monte Carlo Masters, citing that his body is not yet ready for competition. This, of course, raising doubts about his participation in his favourite major, the French Open, really his happy hunting ground. Nadal had initially been expected to make his comeback during the clay court swing leading up to the French Open, in a tournament he has won a record 14 times in his career. However, his withdrawal from the Monte Carlo Masters indicates that he is still not fully prepared to compete at the highest level, or at least at his highest level. So fair game there. But that's where we leave our sporting highlights. We'll delve a little deeper into all of the impending rugby action this weekend. Robbie Gillette is joining us for that. But right now, let's get you prepped for the weekend with the weather.
And you'll need to brace yourself, because it appears as if summer's bidding farewell to South Africa, with disruptive rainfall, flooding and severe cold predicted in 3 provinces. This as the SA Weather Service has issued a warning about a cut-off low and an intense surface high-pressure system set to impact the Cape provinces from tomorrow until Monday. The public and small-scale farmers are urged to prepare for disruptive weather conditions, including heavy rainfall, flooding and icy temperatures in areas of the Western Cape, southern Namakwa in the Northern Cape and the northern parts of the Eastern Cape. This follows prolonged heat waves and below average rainfall in South Africa's interior. Moreover, coastal areas in the Western Cape should brace for damaging winds and waves. Well, if you would love to share your sunrise view with us, do so on our WhatsApp line. That number is 063-408-8863. But let's take a first look at your temperatures for your Friday. Still didn't get the memo.
Come on, man, you got this, man, you got this. No, they're probably the only dry place in the country today. Just stay safe out there. In fact, stay indoors just a little bit longer and maybe play Lotto today. It is massive. You do not want to miss out on this opportunity. So grab your tickets and play Powerball for a remarkable 131 million. I had to double check there. That's this jackpot this Friday, and it could be yours. You don't want to miss out on your chance to win. Ah, just massive. And becoming Zanzi's next multi-millionaire.
Definitely. Now, you can buy your tickets today. You can do so in-store on the nationallottery.co.za website, or you can use their mobile app, or simply buy your ticket through your cell phone banking or by dialing *120*7529# for USSD.
Yeah, I got onto that last week with the last massive Powerball playout. It's a lot easier than you think to get your ticket. Just do it, okay? And don't worry, all of those details will be up on all of our social media pages, so you can go and check them out at your leisure and then start thinking of those lucky numbers and put yourself in line for that life-changing 131 million rand. That's the Powerball jackpot today, and it could be yours.
Oh, how exciting. Well, lots coming up between now and 9 o'clock. So when we get back after the break, we're going to head to Johannesburg. Zanele is touching base with our local artist that's going to perform and make sure your Friday starts.
It's a crew. It's a festival.
It's a whole crew, and it's going to start on the right note.
Exactly. It's an Espresso Weekend festival in Johannesburg, and I want to set the trend right there. Then, of course, got the small matter of some major European rugby coming up this weekend. Robbie Gillette is going to bring us up to speed. We just can't escape that French connection. We'll connect you to that after this.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show. You're still on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, aren't you, on S3? This is where we make sure that your morning is starting off on the perfect note. And this morning, my lovely, the weekend, it is upon us. And this is why we brought some party starters from all around South Africa, all in the name of giving you what you need for it. So one thing I love about music is that it heals, it unites, and it introduces us to all kinds of talent. And today, such talent that we have found right here in the heart of Mzansi. It is five guys who are taking over the music scene. Expresso family, please help me welcome. It is Skills, it is Sykes, it is Live With The Great, Talk Music, and Pushkin! Come on, everybody! Gents, how are they? Hey?
Yeah,
you guys are good?
Nice.
Good. I'm good, thank you. Skills, man. I mean, you're known for being an incredible producer all around the music industry. But of course, Lalela is out, and now we are finding out from you what exactly is it that makes it different from all of the other music that you've dropped?
Okay. Firstly, Kaluk Fia late Josie last year in Pelonyaga.
Yeah.
So basically, before I was doing Ikomu. So ngifikela ngathola inspiration from different producers including Sanel, Nawusax. So yeah, for me it's very special because it's my first single engibona ngathi izophusha kakhulu.
Come on. Yeah. Any intro about you that was tries on genre.
Yeah.
Kill Them All, which I love.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
But speaking of Sykes, Puti, you are someone who just came from being nominated at the Metro FM Music Awards. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Yeah,
so out of all of the ones that you've been nominated for, of course, Song of the Year, there's also Best New Artist, Best Kwaito.com. Which one would mean the most for you to take home?
I think Best New Artist.
Okay. Why?
I mean, statement sakhona ngiyasithanda ukuthi kushuthi ngathini ngiyafisa ukuthi kuvele indlela engifike ngayo kumini special.
Yes.
So ngiyafisa ukuthi kugqame ukuthi usefikile lo.
Oh, come on. And you have arrived, but I mean, all of the hits that you've had and still the hits you're about to have. I was saying at the beginning, Nonke, you owe us music. I know Lalela's out. I know Trevor Chiluga's out, but all of you have been teasing. But let me come to you, Live With The Great. It's in the name, greatest of all time.
Yeah, thank God.
Very quickly, you are somebody who honestly and truly just, you play with a lot of different things. You also sing.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Speak to us about it, you know, when it comes to music and what inspires you and what inspired you to even go into the music industry.
So what inspired me is just my environment, you know, just always, we've been building since way back with the gents. So it's just the chemistry being there, you know, and just being around them like a lot of the time. So I think they inspire me a lot.
I love that. That's so cute. Oh, you need to like romance, leh. Listen, I see it. Talk music. Talk to us, Kengoku, about you and Jaibu Chuluke. Of course, you featured the gents on it. Talk to us where the music talks. Why did you choose these guys to feature on the song?
Well, these guys, from the first go, I know, started as an instrument. I wasn't planning with Ngabafaka, but you know, Sykes was like, Joe, I see your daughter.
Come
and Pushkin was like, Avana, Le. So yeah,
I love
we just dropped it today.
Yes, and literally, I was listening to it on the way here.
Yeah.
And of course, this is the one. Does that make you feel like it is the one, or did you already know it was the one?
It's the one.
I love that. Pushkin. Hi there.
Hola.
Who's that right? Pushkin, congratulations on your EP. Yes, the last time you were here. Welcome back.
Thank you.
I asked you and I said, please, can you feature me on your EP? Awafuna Pushkin.
Awabafana.
Awabafana. Tell us about Time Will Tell, but how is it being received, and you know, who are some of the people that you worked with on it?
Oh, I'm just going to say, like, I work with like my home dudes. My
love that.
Homeboys, actually. And I think I'm going to plug them like in my second EP.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Time Will Tell is coming nicely for me, so yeah.
I love that. Uzonplaga nam? What about Omalume? Tell us.
Esh, Omalume man bekune chemistry nyana yabo. Angithi nangibamba abantu bami. Yibo laba bethu sibathandayo. So nongizoyidrop.
When? Oh my goodness. What is it about you guys and never telling us when you're dropping stuff? I think Sykes was still waiting for Gia, Mama Gia. Where is she?
We are still up.
Oh my God. I'm so stressed. It's fine, guys. Okay. You know, we still have a little bit of time. So I want to play a little bit of a game with you guys, ne?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's called Who's More Likely? Yabo?
Yeah.
So who's more likely to get arrested out of the five of you? I knew it. Okay, who's more likely to meet the president?
This one. For me.
Oh. Okay.
But let's say Lebu for this one.
Lebu.
Lebu. Okay. I love it. I love it. Okay, who's more likely to spend 24 hours in the studio?
Yeah.
Okay, gents, let's talk about 2024. You know, what exactly can we expect from all of you guys? Because, of course, you've got things that are coming up and everything. Yeah, so still, let's talk with you.
Yeah, I'm going to drop a EEP by the end of the year.
Okay.
Yeah, this will be Fisher Richard Sykes.
Yeah.
Yeah, Push King, let's talk. Songage.
I love that.
Yeah.
I'm going to be dropping a joint EP with Ulo Utiman, which features Ikea, Mama Kia.
Yeah.
And a couple of more singles. And then,
come on. Oh, come on. Okay, okay. It looks like the plans are big. We're going to be getting to it, gents, because you're not going anywhere. Yeah. Espresso family, you got to stick around because, as you can tell, the vibes are vibing. And these gents right here, they are going to be giving us the music that we've been wanting and even one of them dropping today. For now, though, it is, of course, the incredible Graham on the other side in Cape Town. Hi, beautiful Graham.
I've actually officially changed my name to The Incredible Graham, okay, after that. Thank you, Zanele, and well done. We've got the crew in the house to entertain. We love that. But lest we forget, we have a massive sporting weekend ahead of us. It's kind of that time of the season, a very exciting weekend looming as the Bulls and the Stormers gear up for some crucial European Champions Cup clashes in the round of 16. It's kind of like the UEFA Champions League of club rugby. The Bulls aiming to secure their quarterfinal spot as they host Lyon at Loft, while the Stormers take on the defending champions La Rochelle at Cape Town Stadium. And we're kind of trading South Africans and Frenchmen through this process. And you had a chat about the weekend's games sports podcaster Robbie Gillette.
Thank you.
You look nervous now. We were all comfortable talking about this. I mentioned the team's names and the French connection, and suddenly now you're like sweating under your collar.
Well, as soon as you say I'm with the incredible...
with the incredible Graham this morning. I'm sorry, man, to put that on your shoulders. But we must be nervous.
Yeah.
These are some big teams. I know these are the two standout South African teams, but when we look at this particular French connection, it comes with pedigree. Yo.
Oh, La Rochelle, double champions, back-to-back champions, Springboks of club rugby, if you would like. But, these guys are seriously good. And especially this La Rochelle side. Dylan Lade's coming back to Cape Town. I mean, the last time he came...
expecting to happen at Loftus this weekend.
Sure, I think playing at home is working for him. It was a tough loss last week at the RDS in Dublin against Leinster, tough Leinster side. It was basically the Irish side. If you look at the Stormers game where they beat us, I said we struggled a little bit. So I think getting back on the wing, get that aerial battle, it's tough to play at Loftus. That altitude gets you. It's going to be a difficult one for Lyon. But Lyon also a side that blows sort of hot and cold. Good at home. And on the road, not so
immense. They've had a phenomenal season playing a beautiful kind of rugby. But maybe Damian Willemse was hinting towards the potential here of this La Rochelle side, trying to soften the blow for his Chinas because he knows what to expect. What is going to go down in Cape Town? How are the Stormers going to broach this one?
As underdogs, I think. Everyone, or bookies are saying that they're underdogs completely.
And Dobbo would like that, I think.
That's sort of their vibe. You know, they'd like to sort of have the spotlight on another side. They've struggled, I think, in the last 2 weeks. Uncharacteristic errors from their side. So I think that's something that they would want to get right this week, and they have to get right. Otherwise, they're not gonna beat this La Rochelle side. And I wouldn't want to be a couple of those boys having to tackle a guy like Will Skelton. That's a big human being. So I think just fixing those uncharacteristic errors, which they can do. We've seen. Sure, the ideal would be other fixtures going the Stormers' way. Definitely, I think I stand corrected, but I think if Leicester beat Leinster in Dublin, Leicester come down, and if we beat La Rochelle, they come down to Cape Town, which will be massive because that's a return of Andre Pollard, and just carry on or build off sort of forget Leinster if you can. I mean, I think everyone in the URC just say, let's forget Leinster, let them win. and we get them in a knockout.
We have high hopes, but I have no doubt that people will be stepping out. If you want to get your tickets at Ticket Pro, you can do it and go out there and support, because I think the lads are going to need us with the French connection this weekend. But here's the added bonus. You stand a chance to win one of three double tickets to either see the Bulls or the Stormers in action. All you have to do is find the competition post, firstly on Expresso's social media pages on all of our platforms, and then answer the following question. Name your favourite current Stormers or Bulls player. I've mentioned mine. Please note that you need to be in either Cape Town or Tshwane to attend the matches. We ain't going to fly you there, or you can do it at your own bank. The competition closes midday today. Obviously, you've got to get on it, but you can find those T's and C's at expressoshow.com. Robbie, enjoy, my brother.
You don't have to ask me twice.
I know, best job in the world. Wherever your allegiances lie, soak it up and enjoy.
Oh, well, listen, still to come on your Feel Good Breakfast show is more sporting action. We're going to take a look at the very exciting cricket season ahead. And then, yes, Chef Clem is here, which means we've got a delicious recipe coming your way. And this time, we're going to do a savory dessert. Ooh, you do not want to miss out on that. It's going to involve a lot of grapes. We'll see you now.
Are you auditioning and getting ready for Tropica Island of Treasure? Well, don't let joint and muscular pain hold you back. Deep Eat is your go-to warm-up solution and SA's number one choice.
Oh, yes, and here's an extra incentive. The top seven contestants heading to the island will each receive 10,000 Rand from Deep Eat. And remember, you can upload your audition with the hashtag Deep Eat and the hashtag Tropica and tag My Tropica.
Who knows, you could be competing in Zanzibar.
Yeah, it's time to reach your full potential.
Get Deep Eat and conquer the island.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back. It is your feel-good breakfast show. It's Espresso on S3. And you're just in time. We're in the kitchen with Chef Clem. And think of this. Crisp, sweet, and perfectly juicy grapes. They are unmatched in their delightfulness. Now, that's why Woolworths, they consistently thrive for excellence when it comes to flavor, quality and sustainability, and their grapes are grown locally in superb locations to deliver the best quality and flavor. Now, Chef Clem, he is here to delight us with something uniquely delicious that's easy to prepare for any upcoming celebrations. So, Chef Clem, what have you got in store for us today?
So there's this trend that started 3 years ago. It's called the savory dessert, which I really like because I don't have a sweet tooth before 10 o'clock at night.
Okay.
After 10 o'clock at night, crazy. Okay, so I always opt for the savory dessert when it is on the menu. And today we're making an example of that.
Okay. Or
it's a very savory kind of like cheese platter. It's fine. Savory sweet, actually.
Okay.
And the reason we get that effect is because we're using the new date syrup. And let me tell you, it is so special. If you roast that with a little bit of lamb, that over a little bit of lamb, some
Ooh.
Herbs, that's sweet. It's got the sweet and tangy sensation, taste.
What is Woolworths doing to us?
It is so good. And it kind of tricks your brain because it gets your brain so like trying to work out what the flavors are. You know, it becomes almost addictive in a sense.
Mm.
It is so delicious. And it's an ingredient and like date syrup has been used for thousands of years and we finally have it on shelf.
We finally have it bottled and packaged.
Yes.
Ready
so,
for it.
Another thing that's happening is grape season.
Yes.
Love grapes.
Well, aren't we coming to the end of grape season? I always assumed it was a summer fruit, but I mean, with Woolworths, it's in store pretty much all year round.
Exactly. And I always know, I know it's grape season because of wine harvest.
So,
working with WKFA, you know. So that February, March time is when they start harvesting. So these are, this is it. This is happening. So they are so delicious. They're absolutely perfect. And the funny thing is, not funny, it's an absolute truth. Since I started working for Woolies 10 years ago, the first thing I learned was before Woolies picks their fruit, they pick their farmers. And I love that. It's so amazing. And the most important recipe that Woolies have is the one that goes back into the soil to ensure that we have the most healthy soil ever. So let's start cooking.
It's so good. Okay, I love how you take a grape for yourself, but you don't share.
I'm sorry, man. I'm so sorry.
I also want one.
People, I actually don't have a preference between the crimson, the green, or the black grapes. It depends on my mood, and I'm loving all of it. That crispiness is
absolutely... So this has a name. It's not the red grape.
This is the...
the crimson.
It's the crimson, and then you got the black one and the green. I love the green because especially the bigger ones, they're like little mini apples. They are big, crispy, and juicy. Love them.
And so for this recipe, can you go with any preference or is it recommended to go with the red grape?
Any preference, actually. I think it might differ slightly, but in a good way. So it's perfectly fine. Go with whatever you prefer. Date syrup goes in. Then where did you find this?
Little Klim.
It's a little Klimchi. Yo.
A Klim and gold.
That, I'm not even gonna use it. I'm keeping this, okay?
That's so pretty.
So what we're gonna do now is, if I could ask you to grab a knife for me.
A knife, a sharp one?
A sharp one, I suppose, and then...
So where the knives are.
Don't worry, I sent you on a mission because I wasn't sure which drawer it was, I'm sorry.
I saw it yesterday, so there you go, nice big knife.
Bay leaves go in, and then we've got some, we actually got some Klim and Gold juice over here, but I'm gonna add some more. No, actually I want the zest.
You want the zest.
So want the zest.
This one.
Take the sticker, keep it, okay. Then
that's something I struggle with, is getting zest.
You know...
The grater sensation doesn't work well with me.
Especially if you have nails. You ever go, you see, I'm terrified as well when I see someone with nails going at it, but just be slow with it, it's fine. That's in. So I'm about to take the juice as well. Can you... So we're gonna go crimson.
Let's go crimson. It's in front of us, it's beautiful. And it's going to work well with the citrusy flavors that you're infusing.
So it's starting to reduce. And what you're going to do when it starts getting like very jammy, that's when you're going to go in with the dunk. And you want to make sure every grape is coated.
Okay. So it's still a little runny. So you want it to reduce a little bit more.
A little bit more. But you can start like getting it in there already. And then it starts doing its thing. And if you want it really syrupy, you get it quite dark.
Okay.
And then quite thick and jammy. I'm not going to do that today. We're just going to get it all coated in. Let that reduce a little bit. And I'm telling you, the flavor's so weird because you've got this intense sweetness coming from the inside of the grape, and you've got this like tartness on the outside, which is, again, it's such a flavor sensation. And we're now pairing it with creaminess.
Oh.
You've got Fior de Latte in front of you, and you can grab your spoon. What's lovely about Fior de Latte is the inside is not set. Not set, it's creamy.
Is this, how would you compare this to a burrata or to, it's mozzarella. It's mozzarella.
Mozzarella. So Fior de Latte mozzarella has got that little bit of extra cream on the inside, which is quite nice when you do with savory dishes because it ends up mixing and becomes a sauce on its own.
Ooh.
So when you do it with this dish, it mixes with that date syrup and it just becomes delicious. Okay, it's got a little bit of a squish. So just put it straight
in the middle.
So you can kind of like, you can either tear it. What do you want to do? A tear? What do you want
to do? I think let's tear it, but okay. I feel like you need to do that part.
There we go. So you just grab it and you just...
And you just open it up.
Just open
Look
it
at
up.
That.
Just break it into a few more pieces. Like that, I like it. Threes, always, odd numbers.
Odd
get
numbers,
your grapes.
For sure.
And you, like again, like you said, get this reduced a little bit more before you put your grapes in, and you're gonna end up with a more intense, thicker syrup. Let's turn this heat up on this one.
Okay.
Or what you can do is you can get them kind of first coated in the syrup while it's not that thick, then reduce the sauce.
And place
and
that.
Drizzle that. Oh, this is a that's the whole bush of grapes.
Yes.
There we go. Perfect.
That and didn't then, help much that you
no,
took
it
off.
What did I do? So with that reduced sauce, let that reduce and then spoon that over. And also serve it with the bay leaves. I think bay leaves are absolutely beautiful served on the plate. Just makes it seem like more rustic-ish-ish.
And it looks like something from a magazine.
You know what? Absolutely. Like, could be perfectly placed in taste.
Ooh.
A little bit extra of the date syrup.
And you've got savory dessert. Absolutely delicious with some mozzarella.
With some mozzarella. There
bay leaves and mozzarella, and you are good to go.
Yeah.
So naturally, you would want that to reduce just a little bit
a
more.
A little more. I mean, you can see how fast it is reducing.
Can you throw a little bit on our mozzarella so the camera
course.
Can get that? That looks good, Chef Clem.
There we go. And you just created a restaurant course at home.
Oh, okay. We need to have a little bit of a taste. So what's the best way to go in? We're going to take a cracker.
Yeah, and then get your spoon, break off a little bit of that mozzarella. Make
gonna
sure you
go
get
in
some
with
of
the
that
mozzarella.
Some of that date dressing. And then with your hand, maybe just
you're
grab
gonna
a
have to. We're going to have
yeah.
to grab a grape. Because we've got the sauce. We've got the jus.
Wow, look at you. Okay.
There's no way this is going to be a TV bite.
It's not going to be a TV bite. My brain's like, what? Wait, is it sour? No, it's not. It's sweet. And then all the flavor comes through, and it's delicious. I'm just eating the grapes with the syrup on it.
There's something about grapes being heated. There's a burst of flavor that comes through. I'm not going to put my grapes in the fridge anymore.
Put your grapes in the fridge. Just do, okay? Absolutely. But I know what you mean. The flavor is somehow intense, and it changes flavor profile. It becomes so different. The first time I ever had a warm grape, I was like, huh? But now, I'm totally with it. It's
profile.
So good. You could also do this. Instead of using the mozzarella, try a really good piece of gorgonzola. That'll be mind-blowing. But it's so good.
This is a winning combination.
Mm.
You actually taste the flavor that comes from the bay leaves slightly. I got that flavor coming through the syrup.
And that's why I always go with, instead of one bay leaf, which I got, this is what I got.
Oh, you only got one.
And I asked for the whole tree. Bay leaves, don't use it sparingly. Just hoy it all in there. Use it. It's an amazing ingredient.
Be generous. This is unbelievable. Thank you for being so generous to come and show us this delicious recipe. Now, you can find this recipe on expressoshow.com. It is pretty straightforward, as Chef Clem has just demonstrated, and it's something you can whip up real quick and easy the next time you have to host or entertain. And you can also do this part of a beautiful cheese board spread. But now listen to this. W Rewards members buy any two seedless grapes and save 15 Rand, while all customers save 10 Rand. Now you can shop this offer until the 7th of April at Woolworths. It's available in store, online, as well as on the Woolies app.
Ah, everything sounds so delicious there in Cape Town, but do you know what else sounds delicious, honey? It is a track that is cooked up by Skills, Live With The Great, and Sykes. It is on the way, yabo. I'm getting the decks ready. I'm just warming it up for them, you know what I mean? Because I told you last time, I'm black coffee, yabo. However, that performance is going to be on your Feel Good Breakfast show. And then, my lovely, we have got an exciting cricket season to look forward to, and we're going to be breaking it down for you right here on your Feel Good Breakfast show. That and a whole lot more is coming up, so make sure you do not go anywhere. You're on S3.
Stand a chance to win your share of 40,000 Rand worth of prizes with the exceptional plush range of household cleaning, leather and shoe care products.
Oh yeah, now to enter, purchase any of the plush ranges, take a photo of you using the products and WhatsApp the picture to 069-201-5794.
And with up to 30% off plush products at major retailers this Easter, what are you waiting for?
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back, you beauties. Thank you so much for choosing to start your weekend with us. And of course, it's a bumper weekend when it comes to sports. Now, we know that cricket is a game of promise, anticipation, jubilation, and a lot of nerves. And from the pitch to the pavement, Western Province cricket players aren't just making a statement on the field, but off the field as well, with their brand new title sponsor saying, oh, Yikomadung, and it is here. In fact, they are here joining us this morning. We delve into the world of Western Province cricket and their incredible new partnerships, and there are some big players in that mix. And some of the players joining us today are Kyle Verena, Eddie Moore, and Leah Jones. Welcome back to the couch. Welcome to the couch,
thank
my
you.
Friend. Leah, so good to see you. Thanks for giving up your early morning, because there is a lot going on in your world at the moment. Seeing as this is the first time we've connected with you on our couch, Eddie, I'm going to start with you, bud. When you've got a big, big name sponsor like World Sports Betting behind you, and people don't make the connections at home that this is part of your, this is your bread and butter. And for you guys to be free to go out there and express yourselves like you are clearly doing this season, so congratulations on that. It helps to have the team around you. What a difference has it made having these guys in your corner this season, man?
Yeah, it's been awesome having a sponsor on board, you know, especially a sponsor like World Sports Betting. You know, it's just nice to have the backing of the community, and, you know, makes our job a little bit easier going out there and express ourselves and, you know, putting in the good performances. So it's been awesome having them on board.
What has clicked for you this season? Because clearly something is feeling good. When you're starting to rack up hundreds, something is working. What has worked for you this year, man?
Yeah, I just think I'm mentally in a good space, you know. Been playing for a few years now, so it's nice to get out there and contribute to the team's success. I think our team culture and environment is really good at the moment.
Yeah.
Putting up some good performances. Yeah, and it's nice to individually to put in some performances for the team and help them get over the line as well.
I love it, and I love the fact that I get to bring my boy to come and watch this, and you haven't lost yet. So in his mind, unbeaten, man. I'm like, I'm not even going to show him any other stats. That's brilliant. We absolutely love that. Leah, this is a big move for women's sport. When we take these little steps and you look back and you see those little increments adding up. I remember speaking to Yandiswa when the announcement was made, and the first thing she said to me was, you know, when the Uber driver stopped me today, he was like, oh, you're going to work today? She was able to say, yes, I'm going to work today. When you've got this kind of partnership and the team around you and you've seen the difference that it's making within the camp, how much of a change, how are you feeling about this partnership?
Yeah, it's obviously something amazing to see. It's not always easy to get a sponsor, especially for women's cricket. So it's great that they are on board, especially for us. And yeah, I think we're excited to see what's to come in the near future with him.
Us as well. We absolutely love the energy and the vibe. Small matter of a bit of derby-ish action coming up this weekend. A couple of big fixtures, kind of two-thirds of the way through the season. What's on the cards? What can the fans plug into? Let's talk about some of the matches that are exciting you and some of the opportunities that might be woven in there.
Yeah, I've obviously got Paul Rocks on Sunday, I think it is, and then we play them again, I think, the following week. So, yeah, it's a local derby, so it's going to be quite exciting.
Love it, yeah.
Looks like we're in a good chance to make the playoffs. So, yeah, it's quite important games coming up.
I love it. Now, of course, we love rewarding the fans for getting really stuck in. And you've brought along some shiny, brand new things here. Can you fill us in just a little bit on what potentially could be won here by some of the fans?
I thought it was mine, actually. I thought they were just going to be. But, yeah, there's three bikes that are up for grabs. I think if you come to the stadium, watch our home games, there's a QR code that you need to scan. Do that, follow the instructions, and you stand a chance to win one of my bikes, unfortunately.
Oh, it's okay, man. Maybe you're just one century away. Just one.
Who knows?
Know, man.
Who
it's knows? Like the hole in one. They are absolutely beautiful. And in fact, I'm going to cross now to Craig Langton, who is sitting very lonesome on the other side. Well, not too lonely, because he's got some beautiful bikes beside him. So, Craig, a very good morning. Thank you for being here, my friend. Can you please take us through Kyle's bikes next to you there? Obviously, a fantastic opportunity for some fans to really get moving. Please introduce us to that beautiful bike stood beside you there.
Yeah, thank you very much. And the bikes we're giving away are, obviously, it's the Hero Eco Deluxe, Hero Motor Corp. They're manufactured in India. And Hero Motor Corp is the world's largest two-wheeler manufacturer.
Wow.
And very focused on women's sport, which I heard you chat about now. They're big sponsors around the world of IPL, golf, at all the rest of it. So as a South African importer, it's our opportunity to give back as well. It's part of the ethos of which we operate and how what the brand stands for. So the Eco Deluxes are sold millions and millions around the world. And they're built for safety and 5 years and 100,000 Ks. In fact, in India, they're used for 20 years.
Wow.
And 500,000 kilometers.
I love that. Sorry, Carl, I think these might be Leah's bikes by the sound of it. I think these might be destined for the ladies' team, and we're okay with that. We obviously have a very special focus on safety here. As you've mentioned, that's part of the brand DNA. Mm. We see some terrible accidents here in South Africa. How do you guys, as a distributor of the company here and the brand manufacturer, Hero, ensure rider safety, or what do you do in that space?
Yes, we're very focused on that approach. So the Hero range that is used commercially for guys that are doing deliveries, and that you can see it's not a delivery bike.
For sure.
And people think that all bikes are the same. The Hero is built to be the safest motorcycle in South Africa at its segment, and it's also built that way with a high DEI and ESG focus, with it being long-lasting so that there's no parts thrown into landfills. And with that ethos, it's the safest motorcycle in South Africa.
Wow. Absolutely love it. Well, thank you so much for being here, for bringing the bikes. We haven't quite yet decided who they're going to go to, but the bottom line is you guys at home could be getting your hands and your butt on one really soon. What you've got to do, though, is get to a game. And Hero South Africa are giving one lucky viewer the chance to win themselves the 2024 Hero X Pulse 200Fi ABS motorbike, valued at a cool 49,900 Rand. Take a gander at that. To enter, what you've got to do is head over to the competition post on the Expresso Facebook, X, and Instagram pages and tell us about your dream biking destination and why you can't wait to explore it. And you better make these good, because I have a feeling we're going to get a lot of entries. Kyle's going to do like 20 on his own. And don't forget to include hashtag World Sports Betting and hashtag Hero South Africa. The competition closes at midday on Monday, the 8th of April. So you don't have a lot of time. It's just around the corner. And those T's and C's can be found on expressoshow.com. The X Pulse dual purpose model has become very popular, obviously, with those who like to use it to commute during the week and then de-stress by having a little bit of fun and playing on the dirt over weekends. And I have a feeling this is the perfect balance. So if that sounds good to you, get those entries in. Ladies and gents, you can start going and penning your entries. Now, all you need to think about is the rest of the season. Keep doing what you're doing. Clearly, there is something in the water in Western Province at the moment. So thank you so much and all the best of luck for this final run-in.
Thank you.
Absolutely love the fact that you guys have the opportunity to win. You can win by going to Western Province, courtesy of World Sports Betting. And of course, you can win right here on the show, courtesy of Hero.
In terms of hearing about all the different ways in which you can win, my lovely, I'm going to tell you about how you're already winning, actually, by being tuned in, into your Feel Good Breakfast show. This morning, we got to speak to some superstars, the guys who are taking over the music industry. And right about now, I'm going to ask you to stand up, Mzansi, and put your hands together for three people who have given us a track that we are in love with. I am talking about Skills, Sykes, and Lebu the Great with La La La. Was about to be started off perfectly. This is what I'm talking about. It's only the first performance that's coming from these gents. Make sure you do not go anywhere. It is still going to be absolutely beautiful because on the way, we are finding out how the landscape of art in South African townships is being elevated, my friend. And we also get to meet the wall mural visual artist, Maleboho, as well as Phebo Fatso. It's still going to be a beautiful time. So make sure you do not go anywhere. You're still on your Feel Good Breakfast show.
Oh man, hopefully you're still bouncing after that performance. Don't worry, the crew ain't going nowhere. Another performance coming your way and a small matter of a Friday dance, possibly, and a lot more in between. We'll be back in the kitchen on the other side of getting into those news and sporting headlines.
Thank you, Graham. Let's start off with local news. The CEO of the new Newland Park Bayhead Rail Terminal in the port of Durban, Raj Balmakun, says the terminal will help to reduce road freight transport on the N3 between Johannesburg and Durban. President Cyril Ramaphosa officially opened the multipurpose terminal yesterday. Balmakun says this is an important development for trade in Africa. The rail terminal forms part of the largest freight transport system on the continent, where ship, rail and road freight can be distributed. The expectation is that this will give trade relations in Africa a huge boost. And staying with our local news, the former Speaker of the National Assembly, Nosisiwe Mapisa Nqakula, was granted bail of 50,000 rand in Pretoria's Magistrates Court yesterday. Mapisa Nqakula faces 20 charges of corruption and one of money laundering related to allegations that she received millions of rand for favours from contractors while Minister of Defence. She resigned as Speaker and MP on Wednesday and handed herself over to the police yesterday morning. She also had to surrender her passport and is not allowed to contact witnesses. The case was adjourned until the 4th of June. We move to news abroad. Aid groups in Gaza are demanding that the Israeli army tighten security procedures to protect their personnel. Seven workers of the NGO World Central Kitchen were killed in a drone attack on Monday. Israel apologized, saying it was a serious mistake. Countries whose citizens were killed in Monday's attack have condemned Israel. Meanwhile, US President Joe Biden has told Benjamin Netanyahu that the US support for Israel will depend on steps being taken to address civilian harm and humanitarian suffering in Gaza. He said the strike and the overall humanitarian situation in Gaza were unacceptable. And Somalia has expelled the Ethiopian ambassador. It has accused Ethiopia of infringing on its sovereignty and internal affairs and recalled its ambassador from Ethiopia. Tension has recently increased due to a controversial agreement between Ethiopia and Somaliland, according to which Ethiopia obtains access to Somaliland's seaport for military and commercial purposes. In return, Ethiopia recognizes Somaliland as an independent state. Somaliland broke away from Somalia some 30 years ago, but isn't internationally recognized as an independent state. Somalia rejected the agreement and accuses Ethiopia of violation of its sovereignty. And amid raindrops, a heartwarming scene unfolded at a South Korean amusement park on Wednesday as adoring crowds bid farewell to cherished giant panda four-year-old Fu Bao at the Everland theme park and zoo, marking her journey to China to join a breeding program. Born in 2020 at Everland, Fu Bao became a beloved icon, doubling visitors after her birth. Her parents were part of China's panda diplomacy program. Clad in raincoats, visitors waved flags and snapped pictures, and with many even shedding tears. As Fu Bao's truck slowly rolled through the streets, adorned with a massive portrait and a touching message, zookeeper Kang Xiol Wan expressed, "You are our baby panda forever, even if 10 or 100 years pass." Well, on that very touching note, that's where I leave those headlines. Let's take another look at your sport.
If by some miracle that didn't do it for you, perhaps your inspiration could be found here in our football. Liverpool surging to the top of the Premier League standings with a gritty 3-1 victory over Sheffield United. They showed some championship-winning credentials there. Darwin Núñez, Conor Bradley exchanging early goals before Alexis McAllister's, as Liverpool now sit 2 points clear of second place to Arsenal in what promises to be an intense title race with just 8 games remaining for each contender. And of course, Man City breathing hard. Now let's drift a little bit lower down the table and another thrilling showdown. Forget about the Fergie Five. Chelsea used all 101 minutes available to them to orchestrate a remarkable 4-3 triumph over Manchester United, effectively a trick, including a nerve-wracking penalty conversion, and then, of course, a sensational winner in stoppage time. So the crushing defeat, leaving United languishing, now propels them to 10th place on the table, reigniting their European ambitions after a roller coaster season under Pochettino. Now let's turn to tennis and some great news as we build towards the end of the season. The Women's Tennis Association has now confirmed that Saudi Arabia will host the WTA Finals for the next 3 editions. That's from this year to 2026. So the season-ending tournament will take place in the capital city of Riyadh, with the first edition scheduled from the 2nd to the 9th of November this year. The deal comes after months of speculation and some criticism, but the WTA has now silenced that, expressing excitement about bringing a women's tournament of this magnitude to this part of the world. I think it will make a big difference. The agreement also includes a significant increase in prize money, about time, a record $15.25 million offered for this year's tournament. That's fantastic news. But not so much when we look at the men's side of the next tennis draw. Rafa Nadal has confirmed that he is withdrawing from the upcoming Monte Carlo Masters, citing that his body is just not ready yet for competition. So this obviously raises doubts about his participation in his favourite major, his happy hunting ground, the French Open. Nadal had initially been expected to make his comeback during the clay court swing leading up to the French Open, a tournament that he has now won a record 14 times. Incredible. However, his withdrawal from the Monte Carlo Masters does indicate that he is still not fully prepared to compete at his highest level, let's say. I'm sure he could still give it a go, but that's rougher. And we'll leave that there. In terms of our sport, we'll touch on those headlines again in about an hour or so. But right now, the roads should be up and running. Let's get you to work safely.
Thank you, Graham. Let's start off with traffic in Midrand, Johannesburg. There's been a multi-vehicle accident on the N1 southbound at Olifantsfontein Road. That left lane's affected and traffic is slow moving. Moving to Germiston in Johannesburg, there's a stationary truck on the N3 southbound, and that's after the ramp from Van Buren. The left lane is affected and there are delays. Exercise caution while driving. That's your traffic. Let's take another look at your weather. And it appears as if summer's bidding farewell to South Africa, with disruptive rainfall, flooding and severe cold predicted in three provinces. This as the SA Weather Service has issued a warning about a cut-off low and an intense surface high-pressure system set to impact the Cape provinces from tomorrow until Monday. The public and small-scale farmers are urged to prepare for disruptive weather conditions, including heavy rainfall, flooding and icy temperatures in areas of the Western Cape, southern Namakwa in the Northern Cape and the northern parts of the Eastern Cape. This follows prolonged heat waves and below average rainfall in South Africa's interior. Moreover, coastal areas in the Western Cape should brace for damaging winds and waves. Well, that is your weather update. Let's take a look at your sunrise views. Maureen is kicking us off for our 7 a.m. update with a beautiful sunrise view from Yellow Sands on the East Coast. Thank you for this. And if you would love to send us your sunrise view, do so on our WhatsApp line. That number is 063-408-8863. Here's another look at your temperatures for your Friday.
To listen very carefully right now. Grab your tickets and play Powerball Plus for a, or Powerball at least, for a remarkable 131 million Rand jackpot today. That's this Friday. You do not want to miss out on this chance to win big and become Mzansi's next multi-millionaire. It is massive. You can buy your tickets today really easily. You can do it in-store. You can go to nationallottery.co.za online. You can use their mobile app. You can use your banking app. And you can also get through the traditional cell phone banking or simply by dialing *120*7529 hash for USSD. And we'll keep all of those details up on the Expresso social media pages for as long as we need to, so you can check them out and you can put yourself in the running for that life-changing 131 million Powerball jackpot today. Play now and good luck. Now, that's someone's story changed forever, and your story really does matter. That's why we're going to be telling your story in the most incredible murals across South Africa, transforming our landscape. And then, of course, we're going to introduce you to two phenomenal artists spearheading this campaign. We cannot wait for that. We'll shed some light after this.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Oh, I can't tell you just how good it is to be with you, Espresso family. Thank you so much for deciding to start your morning with us, because we love it when we're together, yeah? We always get to either get into some music or maybe have some really important chat. It's always fun, though, and that's the most important thing. And what I love is that our bank, APSA, is doing the most in terms of elevating the art scene in townships all around South Africa. From the picturesque landscapes of the Western Cape to the hustle and bustle that happens in Johannesburg, they are doing huge things with 156 interactive wall murals all around the country. And it is so beautiful to see, because they are also 100% making sure that artists around the country are getting a platform and are being seen, which I think 100% also speaks to exactly what it is when we talk about that APSA is investing into making sure that diverse narratives do really matter. So from APSA, everybody, please would you welcome the queen who is here to tell us all about it. It is Sadiqa Fakir.
Hello.
Hi, beautiful Sadiqa. How are you?
Very well, thank you. And you?
Amazing, thank you. You guys are doing such a great job. I tell your colleagues all the time when they come and sit here.
I feel so honored and so blessed to be a part of this ACE team, to be really, really driving the narrative, because we truly believe that we see an opportunity in every story, and every story matters.
I love that. So speak to us about that, because yes, your story matters is your new brand ethos.
And so does yours.
Yeah, oh, thank you. So does yours, Sadiqa. Speak to us about how this now plays into you guys and your inspiring wall mural campaign.
The thing is that we've landed our new brand positioning, which is your story matters, and it really speaks to the heart and not just the mind.
It does.
And now partnering with communities, artists from around Pan-Africa, to really use art as the mechanism or the catalyst to tell their stories.
Yeah.
And that's something that we really, really were passionate about. We've used participating artists, some winning artists from our La Atelier competition, which is a Pan-African art competition.
Come on.
To really partner with us and really make townships picturesque and adorn these townships and communities with their beautiful artwork. So really breaking boundaries of art being for a specific sect of human individuals, but really saying art is for everyone and using art to tell the stories.
I love that. So how are you guys going to do that, especially in terms of speaking to these artists that you're calling to come out?
So we have 156 wall murals across communities and townships, which we are absolutely thrilled about. And coming for marketing, it's a matter of you could place marketing or you could be purposeful about the story you're telling with marketing or the platforms we're using for our brand positioning. And the wall murals were exactly this. So it's something that sits close to our hearts. Using the 156 wall murals and partnering with 8 artists from around the country, close to where they live. So it's something that's very, very close to their hearts as well. And using those canvases to tell their story through art.
I love that. So how are you going to get these artists to come out and be a part of this incredible thing that you're doing?
So they already are.
Yes.
We've selected them through our La Atelier competition. We have 8 amazing artists who will be partnering with us and currently partnered with us because it's currently in rollout. And they've worked with our teams to actually adorn picturesque Western Cape, hustling and bustling Johannesburg across the country with their beautiful pieces of unique art. Now, this is an interesting thing. Communities now become art galleries.
We've
broken the boundaries to go, I don't need to just go into an art gallery. I'm walking, I'm going here, I'm going there. And now I get to view and encapsulate this art and really wonderful ways to tell stories. I think the other amazing thing about our wall murals is that 50 of the wall murals are going to be Wi-Fi enabled. So they're going to it's very cool.
Oh my word.
This is where digital meets the traditional world, right?
So I love that.
A little bit of a geek here. I get very excited about this because as the team, we said, how do we make this experience a lot more immersive and tell the stories through the art? So you're going to have QR codes or scannable codes.
Yeah.
And anyone who's viewing this art can scan the codes. And as they're viewing this beautiful piece of art, they can grab the artist's story as well and the inspiration behind the artwork. Aww. So a completely immersive experience.
That's so beautiful. And can I tell you something else that I always really love is when you take something that's not particularly in the township and you bring it to them, because a lot of the time you can't be what you don't see. So whether it's the township or in just any community where kids are just not exposed to all of these different, you know, places and things, now you allow them to be like, actually, I do want to be an artist.
You're absolutely right, because we were growing up, and when I grew up, personally, my story was I couldn't take art as a career.
Yes.
It had to be a commercial career. We are encouraging the youth as part of this drive. You can be anything you want to be. You can use art as the mechanic to drive your career,
yes,
but also to drive your story.
I love that. So tell us very quickly, please, how long are they going to be up and everything we need to know?
They're already up, 25th yes. of March until the 30th of June. You've got to be a story spotter and really look out for those beautiful pieces of art.
Yeah, I love it. Oh, man, I told you, Absa's always doing the work that matters, and this is why we love it. And don't forget, your story matters. And this is why, as well, we get to go and see these murals. But as you heard from Sadiqa, 25th of March up until the 30th of June. So you've got a lot of time, my love, but go now to go and see and go and learn about all of those stories. It's so beautiful to be able to have these conversations, like I said, the ones that are so important and all about the things that genuinely make South Africa that much greater. But now, though, make sure you do not go anywhere. You're still on your Feel Good Breakfast show.
There are stories of believers, and we're inspired by them all. We invite you to write your story with us. Your story matters. Absa.
Now, just to prove that she really is the hostess with the mostess, Zanele Potelwa, our very own Zanele, will be hosting Tropica Island of Treasure. And, of course, joining her in Zanzibar is an A-list, list of A-listers. We got Bobby van Jaarsveld, Umutle Gela, Chad Jones, Ndavi Nokeri, Carl Kuhlman, Nkobile Kwezi, Hungani and Ndlovu, and you. Possibly. Ooh. You could be heading to Zanzibar as well. And here is a little look at what your competition potentially looks like.
Hi, my Tropica Island. My name is Whitney Dubrain. I'm from Genvista, Johannesburg. And in this new chapter of 30, I believe I have what it takes to be a part of my Tropica Island Season 11 in Zanzibar. I'm a professional dancer and an event floral designer. I'm not just your ordinary contestant. When it comes to adventure, I don't just dip my toes in the water, I dive in headfirst for the win. I'm looking forward to making this a reality and making this island adventure unforgettable. I will see you there.
Hi, Tropica family. My name is Anna Simagade, all the way from the Eastern Cape. Ekonglepawa. My bags are packed. Passport is ready. I am ready to go to the island. Family, oh my God, this is so exciting. This is me auditioning for a chance to go to Zanzibar. I am ready. Are you ready, guys, to see this bubbly person there by Zanzibar? Oh, God, I'm so excited. Passport is ready. That's the fact. Ditimile kwetini. Tropica family, please choose me.
We welcome the throttle body head knock, Mr. Dylan Wannenberg.
Oh, for obstacle course. I can take on any obstacle that comes my way. C, I can carry anything or anyone, big or small. K, for knowing how to get through a difficult time. N, for numbers. Numbers don't lie and you'll always be able to count on me. B, for brains. Whether it's a puzzle or needing a solution, or even directing you in the right direction, I'll always do my best. H, for hunting. Hunting is my second name, and always hungry to get down and dirty. N, for never giving up. Once I was attacked by a crocodile, I didn't give up. I kept fighting, and I swam all the way from Robben Island all the way to Cape Town, just for a tropical. And this is why I should be a tropical season.
Pretty cool. I love how he called a croc.
Croc. Oh, love it. The most dangerous animal in the world.
Oh, well, listen, how incredible was that? Well, if you want to be part of that incredible pool of individuals that get selected to go to Zanzibar, then upload your auditions to social media by tagging at MyTropica and including that hashtag Tropica for a chance to head to Zanzibar. And if posting publicly isn't your thing, you can now also upload your auditions using the links provided that will be found on MyTropica on social media pages or by emailing your audition to tropicaauditions@gmail.com.
But forget that. Put it out there. We want to see it, man. We want to see it as well. We might even put it on the show. So remember, those seven contestants chosen to go over to Tropica Island of Treasure will each receive 10,000 rand even before you get to Zanzibar. And that's courtesy of DP. Start working those aching muscles because you best be in gym training right now if you want to book your spot on that island because it's going to be physical. Man.
Yes, yes. Well, you've got some time because auditions will close on the 5th of May, which is just around the corner. And don't miss your chance to win your share of 1 million rand. Now that is smooth. There are some T's and C's that apply.
Good morning, Bobby.
I've got Umuhle. Oh. There we go.
He's so good looking. Look at him, man.
We're in Zanzibar for Tropical Island of Treasure. Are you? Did you just swim here from South Africa? There's an easier way to find fame and your share of a smooth million-rand fortune. Simply upload your audition to social media, explain why you're a match for our celebs. Add the hashtag Tropica and tag at MyTropica, and we could see you in Zanzibar. Buy a Tropica now and enter to be on the island.
So we'll get you inspired to get out there, whether you're going to Zanzibar or any other adventurous location. We've got some amazing hiking gear. When I say amazing, really cool. You're going to lust after this stuff. We absolutely love it. And then, of course, we've got a lot more happening within the kitchen. We are going to be whipping up a spinach strawberry salad with feta and almonds. I'm trying to visualize
it
right now.
Keeping it healthy today.
We have to after post-crazy long weekend eating, but that looks scrumptious. And yes, very healthy. We shall be back in the kitchen on the other side.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. We're still in the business of feeling good here on Expresso because it is your feel-good breakfast show after all. You're still on S3 and honestly, my friend, this morning is just so beautiful because we are talking about inspiring stories. We heard about how APSA is doing the things that need to be done in terms of elevating the townships in and around South Africa with the art scene that is going places, my lovely, because of APSA and 8 incredible artists who have come out and said, look, I want to be a part of this. So what exactly am I talking about? I mean, their wall mural campaign. It is so beautiful to see how many we are seeing all around South Africa, 156 to be exact. And this morning, we actually get to be joined by two of the visual artists that are part of this incredible campaign. Everybody, please put your hands together for Pepo Fatso and Malebogo. Hello, hello, guys.
Hello, hello.
Good and you?
I'm good, thank you. How does it feel to be this talented?
At times, it's nice, but it's scary.
It's okay, okay, yeah. I get it. It can be scary.
Yeah, it has its own challenges. Oh, that's fine.
My babes, we are glad that you are sharing your art with us. That's what we are happy for. But guys, let's dive into this because honestly and truly, I feel like this is such a great thing that you are partnering with an entire APSA and an entire APSA is partnering with you.
An entire because, one.
Yes, entire you as well. Let's talk about the fact that, you know, your installations are up in South Africa. Let's speak about yours first, Malebogo.
Okay, my installation is an illustration. Mm-hmm. It's based on a painting. I decided to use 3 colors mm-hmm. because each color has a meaning. So yes. It's black, white, and red.
Yeah.
So black is for strength, red is for emotions, mm-hmm. and white is it's for innocence.
I love that.
Yes, the reason why I did this, it's based on my personal journey from my childhood until to this day. So breaking away from all the norms and having to become a successful artist, yeah. I'd say.
That's so, beautiful. Yeah. Oh, Pepo Fatsoen, what about you? Tell us about your installation.
Well, for me, I think it's a lot more kind of more conceptual than mm-hmm. that. You know, like my artwork is really, is actually just a new electrical circuit.
Okay.
But the idea is to actually show that, you know, like people, ideas, and everyone is really just connected to the, you know, to the world and to the, yeah, like, to the world at large.
Yes, we're all connected, and it's, yeah. it's very, very true, which is why we're able to connect through your guys' art. So shout out to you.
Thank you.
I want to come back to you, Malebogo, because of course we know that Absa's telling us your story matters. So let's speak about your story. What is your story when it comes to this specific artwork? You kind of touched on it a little bit now, but go deeper, my love. We want to hear about the story.
Mine is very personal, honestly. It's from failure to success.
Sure.
So it's based on my past, my present and future. Mm. So the reason, if you can see, I'm just trying to encourage people to understand that everybody goes through pain. Mm. So it's okay to make mistake and allow to make mistake. But if you desire to do something and yeah. you're very confident of what it is you need to do, so you get there and do what it is needed of you. So what happened on my past, hence I have failure, you will see that I did all these sports.
Yeah.
So I had an incident which was very painful. Mm. I remember 2008, I was told that amongst 146 students, only 145 passed. And I'm that one individual that did not pass.
Oh, man.
So that broke me. That gave me like depression and all that. Mm. I wasn't coping, but I thought, how is it possible that they saying that I failed, but I got a bursary to study engineering?
Look at that.
So it was very confusing. So I got into a sports academy program with the Impala Platinum. Mm. So everything kept on working well. I went and rewrote, but did my supplementary and all that, but they still told me, like, there's no change in everything.
But now look at you today, Malebogo.
But look at me now.
And so, this is the yes. thing. So, that's such a beautiful story.
So you can imagine from working underground for 4 years and deciding to go back to school and study art.
That's incredible. Look,
yeah. Oh. And I was called the 2022 Jared Sakota Award winner.
That's so right!
You can see, as a black female yes. and being the black glass artist to ever win within this Jared Sakota prize, it's that thing as an upset Latilia, I managed to tell myself, you know what? Okay, you're breaking through the norms, you're strong, you're a strong black woman,
and
you're out
it.
Here to like challenge yourself and inspire others.
That's exactly what I was about yes. to say. Thank you very much, Oprah.
Thank you.
It was so lovely to hear from you. Now, so we want to hear your story very quickly, but we want to hear it right now. Yes.
Well, like, how can I top Oprah over here?
Okay, so I'll give you 30 seconds to tell us what it is that it matters in terms of your story and this mural.
Perfect. Mm. Well, so I think starting off, I always wanted to be an artist.
Yeah.
I don't think that there was any other way.
Yeah.
But I couldn't really see, you know, a pathway to being an artist, really, until university. I actually began to actually go to the Absa Atelier Awards.
Yeah.
And, you know, to the gallery and their shows, and I actually could see a path, you know, and then, like, I could see how other artists are charting their own path.
Yes.
And then I thought that that was great.
That really speaks to exactly what you guys are doing right now, because yeah. your murals being up, there's young kids who are looking at you and looking at what you do and being yeah. like, yes, I want to do that.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
thank you for that, guys. This is why your story matters.
100%.
These are two artists who have partnered with Absa, all in the name of their incredible wall mural campaign. My lovely, they are up in all the townships that you can find in terms of Absa and this incredible campaign. 156 of them, actually. And these two have got their murals up there. It's so incredible. Don't forget, from the 25th of March all the way until the 30th of June. For now, we've got our family standing by in Cape Teasy. Hi, my Graham and my Zoe.
So after indulging in all of the Easter weekend festivities, and yes, we did indulge, there were lots of treats last weekend, which was okay. We now nourish our bodies with some fiber to keep our tummies happy and healthy, because we got to do it. But that doesn't mean it doesn't have to be just as delicious and enjoyable. Step in our incredible salad today. And there was something very special, Zoe, about the combination of strawberries and balsamic.
The more
funky, the better. Strawberries have a beautiful kind of fresh, fruity flavour, a little bit of acidity, but I think the two work beautifully together.
They do, and pair that with some feta and a bit of a crunch, we are making the most beautiful salad. And for that balsamicness that you love, we're going to start with the dressing. We're going in with some olive oil, a little bit of balsamic vinegar, and then we're going in with some shallots.
Nice. Why were you so nervous about saying shallots?
Shallots.
Just embrace
shallots.
It. Shallots.
And then some salt and pepper for seasoning. So we'll just go in generously with the salt. I've been loving pepper lately, so we're going to go hand of pepper.
Oh, for sure. And you're on the money there. Black pepper and strawberry. They say it's one of those flavour activators. We know that very often we don't use salt as a saltiness. We use it to activate the other flavours that we mix with it, which is why it's so dominant. And the reason why pepper has earned its place at salt side is because it's just a perfect complement.
It really is. And then this dressing simply goes over our baby spinach leaves, and we will make sure it's beautifully coated.
And I think the baby spinach is perfect. It's got a slightly kind of less harsh flavour profile than the grown-up spinach, if you will. So it's generally my go-to. Very, very nutritious. Obviously, incredible fibre in there. Great iron as well. A really, really super green. If you're going to get greens into your diet, this is right up there. Now, of course, I'm slicing up the strawberries. I'm doing slightly longer slices because you want to really hero these little guys. But they are beautiful, and you do get kind of a nice balance of sweetness and that tartness, the acidity, which I think will work really well. And then, of course, the balsamic's got a natural sweetness to it as well. And if you're lucky enough to have one of those really funky aged balsamic reductions, rock and roll, because I think that'll be
roll. And you just want to coat everything beautifully in it. Of course, if you're making this salad in advance, maybe keep the dressing until just before serving. You don't want your, you know, your beautiful baby spinach to go soggy. You want that crunch. We want that. And we're making a beautiful big salad. This is now a family-sized salad.
Okay. All for two. Depending on how hungry
how hungry you are, and if you love your leafy greens.
Because sometimes, and we talk about all the indulging over this weekend and the indulging that's going to happen over the next weekend as well. It is important to look after your body, but also to have a little bit of fun. And this is the kind of salad that will get that dopamine release. It's got all of the beautiful flavors. You can start spreading those guys around. Absolutely beautiful. I think there is something so pleasing about the pop of color when you get a salad right. That balance, the stark contrast, the juxtapositioning, if you will, of the strawberries, absolutely gorgeous to look at, even better to eat.
I feel like I've been traumatized with salads that are made with lettuce, but just normal lettuce and lack of creativity.
For sure.
That when you make a salad with baby spinach leaves, it always just looks, feels, and everything tastes better.
Yeah, and it's got a nice kind of bite to it. It's nice and crunchy, but it's not too much. It's not too kind of herbaceous. It's not over the top. And when I talk about spinach being just an absolute king when it comes to the vitamins that are involved, the iron that's involved, it is so good for your tummy and, of course, the fiber. And if you can have something like this, especially if you're breaking a fast, if you can get those leafy greens or some really good fiber in, you are doing yourself a favor. Only 7 calories per cup, okay? That's an incredible jumping off point for our baby spinach. Healthy dose of vitamins A and C, plus folate, you've got the iron, as I said, even calcium involved here, which is great. And then we're adding even more healthy oils through our nuts that are a little bit toasted. And I think the saltiness of the feta is the perfect balancing act here. I think that just
really
caps
is.
It off beautifully. Well done.
Look at that. Ours looks, we've got nuts to spare.
Yeah, exactly. And you can snack on little things as you go. It's beautiful. Every mouthful is going to be an absolute experience. We love it. Now, of course, if you've taken your indulgence just too far, sometimes you need to lean on a little bit of help. And for reliable and effective relief from that occasional constipation, Microlax works from 5 to 15 minutes versus the oral treatment, which can take anything between 2 to 72 hours to really kick in. So if you need help and need it fast, this is your go-to. It's easy to use, gentle to administer, which is not like a regular enema. Don't worry, it's going to be okay. It's suitable for adults and for babies, which proves just how safe it is. The elderly, young babies, most susceptible to constipation. In fact, this is a massive, massive help. So get over yourself, check your baggage at the door, and talk about it if you need to. Microlax is suitable and convenient for both and everyone in between. That's ourselves included. So you've got that special person in your corner when you really do need help. And if you want to get your hands on this delicious recipe, visit espressoshow.com. So let's bid adieu to the occasional constipation concerns and welcome a fresher, more energized version of ourselves with open arms. Mm-hmm. I love it. Absolutely beautiful.
Incredible.
Oh, we need a... I was going to say, do you want to have a taste? Use the spoon.
Use the spoon. I'll use this one. You can use that one. It's just got some leaves on it.
And you want to make sure you get a little bit of absolutely everything in there.
Strawberry. And the nuts.
So now what you're going to do, if you happen to be going hiking and you want to take this as your kind of hike course, you've got to keep your dressing separate in a little container, and then you keep the salad in this and your little cooler bag and your awesome rucksack, and then you can mix it all together on the mountain.
Oh, beautiful. Mm. I love the balsamicness coming through. And you were right. The pepper, balsamic and strawberry is a winning combination.
Just sings.
This is beautiful. Well, and it's the type of food you'll take a bite and you want to dance. So we've got more entertainment coming your way from Johannesburg with Zanele. We've got more music, so don't go anywhere.
And we might just take you hiking with this celebrity. We're going to introduce you to the coolest hiking gear to get you out onto your adventure on the other side of this. It looks so pretty.
Yay. Oh, you can make my day.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Hello, adventurer enthusiasts. Are you ready to embrace the great outdoors regardless of the weather? Well, this season is a magical time to explore the diverse landscapes of our beautiful country and indulge in some cozy getaways here in South Africa. Hikes, something for everyone to enjoy this chilly season, with an opportunity to connect with nature, get some of that green energy, and of course connect with loved ones. And we're going to connect you to adventure as we dive into a couple of the essentials that you might need for hikes, with some quality gear and apparel from Cape Union Mart that will make this winter season unforgettable.
Yes, well,
beautiful.
I'm actually taking note because I've got my ticket to the Otter Trail soon. So I'm really excited. And the first thing I was told is make sure you have the correct socks. So first we have merino wool socks. Now, these socks are top notch. They are right here. This is for the men. That is for the lady. And it's crafted from the finest luxurious merino wool that they offer superior thermal insulation and protection against the cold. Plus, thanks to the special 100% recycled.
Wow.
This is eco, really cool wool, and the technology and yarn, the moisture, it is also, it wicks away any moisture that you might have. Because you know, some of these hikes, if you go super early in the morning,
just sodden, you still
do, and you don't want that on your feet, and it's gonna keep your feet cool and dry. Plus, they are full cushioned for maximum comfort. You're gonna spend a lot of time on your feet. And also, it has a fine toe seam to prevent blisters and a beautiful mesh panel for breathability. So this is what you are looking for in beautiful socks. Can you see that?
Maximum support. I think the arch support is vitally important because you're using that extension and your calves so much. Your foot works on a hike. That kind of carries the load. So
you
anything.
Want the cushion.
Yeah, completely. But also you don't want squelchy toes in your brand new boots. So with the socks sorted, what are socks without shoes, in fact? And we need some that can match the adventure. And we've got these men's and women's absolute winners here. The K-Way Edge 4 mid waterproof hiking boots. They are beautiful, first of all. Just take a look at that design. It's like something from Batman.
So sleek.
Hey, just really, really cool. They're also eco-friendly. They're made from recycled materials. That is brilliant. And they are built to last, because you need to know they're going to go the distance. They've got a beautiful, durable ripstop upper with TPU support. Then they've got comfy Ortholite sock liner and a breathable mesh as well, even adding more breathability. And then high traction rubber outside for unbeatable grip. And these are gorgeous. They look like they can catch a bit of pace as well.
They're stylish. They match your outfit today.
Oh,
both pairs.
I'll do it. I will do it. Now, absolutely beautiful.
I feel like for any hiker, you need the ultimate hiking bag. So let me just show you this one. I need to put it on because here is the K-Way Pioneer. It's a 65 liter, plus you have an additional 10 liter hiking pack. And this is for your adventures. This is going to be your sidekick. And some of these features include, it's got a wide hip belt, so it gives the support. So when you carry everything
as well, for sure.
Your hips are carrying majority of the weight. Obviously, you'll adjust it to fit your hips, and you can just simply clip it in. I love how I'm doing this.
That is a game changer.
It is a game changer. And then, of course, it's stretchy. It's got lots of pockets for all your things. It's also got dual attachment points for different back length, so you can, you know, adjust it.
You can
fully
move it up or down according to your height. Oh, that is brilliant. It's so funny. I'm just thinking of this in the context of a baby carrier, because that's how my mind works when it comes to the lower lumbar support. But you don't understand. Yeah, for 15 minutes, you're fine with the wrong kind of bag. 2 hours later, very different story. You need that lower lumbar support. You know what you look like? You look like the incredible pilot of an aeroplane that went down in the Andes and is just walking her way out. She's like, I've got you people, follow me.
Follow me. And you just obviously tighten it to make sure that everything is beautifully and secure. Because that if there's a tiny niggle and you don't address it in the beginning of your hike, it is going to bother you by the
end
of your
hike. It'll eat you up, yeah, for sure. And I like the fact you can have your phone in there, you can have your accessories that you need.
I don't think you would want your phone on a beautiful hike. You would want snacks. Snacks, water, easy accessible, but it also comes with a handy rain cover coat. So, you know, sometimes you have those unexpected showers. Plus, there's this bonus detachable cargo net for more space. And there's also the lid that transform into a 15-litre day pack. Now, how cool is that?
If you just want to use the top can go on a hike in your hike, inception hikes. I love that. But you do. You want to set up a base camp and then go and just enjoy and explore. So you don't want to be fully kitted up as well all the time.
And but it's easy.
Look
it's
at
all
that.
About picking it up and being convenient.
It looks absolutely cool and very lightweight as well. Very, very cool. I absolutely love that. So let's look at what we can wear underneath one of these. And we're going to go the eco-friendly route again. K-Way's Iris Eco Fleece Polo Neck. This one's for the ladies. Dusty pink, absolutely beautiful. Soft and warm. The K-Way Iris Eco Fleece Polo Neck is ideal as an insulation layer under your jacket or an overlayer while exercising. And I like the fact that it's light enough to be able to do that. And obviously handles the sweat and the moisture as well. And you'll love the fact that it's made from, as we said, a very lightweight fleece that's perfect for traveling, excellent fabric recovery for improved fit with a high neckline for improved insulation. And it includes a wicking finish which removes moisture from the skin. And I like this. This seems to be the buzzword in the hiking world at the moment, this wick ability for, and that's the technology that's literally interwoven into these garments at the moment, is they will draw the moisture out.
It will.
Put it out there in the world.
It definitely will. Now, we covered the ladies. Let's focus on the men, the K-Way's men Marco brushed fleece. This jacket is also, you know, the gents with the macro fleece jacket by K-Way. You can feel it is comfortable, it is warm, and it also features a full zip front, elasticated hem, elasticated cuffs, and also some pockets too for all the gadgets that you want to encourage.
Lovely. Just have another little look at that.
Here we go.
How do you know you've seen a South African in an airport?
They wear their K-Way.
Yeah, just look for that little brand name there. Absolutely stunning.
Oh,
I love it.
But I feel like this is the iconic South African jacket.
Yeah, that is the OG and the one to have. The K-Way Men's Creek Down Jacket. It is lightweight, made from, again, 100% recycled, 90 to 10 down feather. I don't know what that means, but I would imagine it's a good down ratio. Now, it's not overloaded because it's in South Africa. We're not in Europe, but it still gets cold. So that down is a game changer. The perfect cold weather protection. Come wind, come rain, it doesn't matter. It's got you sorted for all of your outdoor adventures.
Ah, perfect. Well, we can't forget about the ladies because we also have the women, the K-Way Women's Robin Down Jacket. And this K-Way beautiful. Robin Down Jacket, it is beautiful and also lightweight and highly compressible, and it is made with duck down and the perfect insulator for your next adventure. When we say it's perfect, there's normally a little bag in one of these pockets and you can fully fold. I need to feel
I know, and do you know how proud I was of keeping that? I
this
lose
little baggie.
Everything and I've still got my, and of course I've got the green K-Way.
This jacket folds into this teeny tiny baggie, but the down part, the down counterpart, it offers the resistance against wind and water while keeping you cozy.
I love it.
So and fashionable.
You can put the jacket in the little bag, and you can put the little bag in one of your front pockets on your strap there, and no one will even know that you're carrying a whole jacket with you. These are beautiful. They look amazing, but they deliver. When it comes to the technology behind these garments, that's where the game really changes. So this winter, get ready to be connected to adventure by Cape Union Martin. To get your hands on these incredible items and a whole lot more, to be inspired, go and browse online, capeunionmart.co.za, or do yourself a favor and step into a store.
Definitely, and enjoy the outdoors and get connected with nature this winter with adventure. It starts here.
I want the boots. I want those so bad.
I'm keen on the bag. Nice big one.
Yo, these are. Now, when you talk about adventurous spirits, these two have them, Fez and Anes, who continue their incredible journey on Top Travel in Botswana. And that's the latest episode of Top Travel.
How exciting. Now, this season of adventure, it is brought to you by Halls and the power of menthol, giving the two hosts a time to refresh and refocus to take on the moments.
Because you do need to stop, pause sometimes and refresh. And Botswana is home to one of the seven natural wonders of the world. You might not know the incredible Okavango Delta, home to around 130,000 elephants. They've been able to protect one of our greatest natural resources, one of the biggest populations of elephants in the world. I would assume the biggest, actually.
Yes.
That is incredible.
Oh, well, let's take a look at what Fez and Anesu explore this week.
Channel your inner explorer on Top Travel this Saturday night at 8:30 on S3 as Fez and Anesu follow the river that never finds the sea into Botswana's Okavango, jewel of the Kalahari.
This is nothing short of a magical experience, and to be so close to all the action is really a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
Fez comes face-to-face with his spirit animal, and the best suite in the Delta is a bed beneath the stars on top of a baobab tree. That's Top Travel this Saturday night at 8:30, repeat Sunday at 1 p.m. on S3.
Oh, man, and after spending some time with Anais, who is just a gorgeous human being, I'm even more emotionally invested in that journey. But can you imagine sleeping? They saw a leopard, first of all, which no one ever gets to see, sleeping on a baobab tree in five-star luxury.
Oh,
come on.
That's how it should be. Now, Top Travel, it airs Saturdays at 8:30 p.m. on S3 with repeats on Sundays at 1 p.m. So tune in to catch the latest adventure. Mm-hmm.
And there's an added bonus. You stand a chance to win a trip to Amsterdam. Maybe we should have started with that one. Here's how you do it.
Breathe for it with Halls and stand your chance of winning a trip to Amsterdam with two return economy tickets on KLM Royal Dutch Airlines and 20,000 rand spending money. KLM invites you to take a seat on board, enjoy the snacks and drinks that are included in your ticket, charge your phone, connect to Wi-Fi, or watch a movie. You could be the lucky Top Travel viewer to win this adventure of a lifetime by telling us how you take a moment to refresh and refocus with Halls. Comment on Top Travel's competition social posts by using hashtag TopTravelTV and hashtag Halls. Breathe for it. T's and C's apply.
I always tell you, if you're tuned into S3 between the hours of 6 and 9 a.m. on a weekday, then, my lovely, we got so much that is in store for you. First and foremost, we got an Eid table setting that is going to be given to us by Raisa Makuse. It is on the way. Make sure you do not go anywhere. But then, you see these guys behind me. I'm starting a band, baby. Starting a band. I'm joking. They have their own, okay? And they are going to be making us jive. Tell me Juluk, okay? Jive Juluk by Talk Music, as well as Sykes and, of course, Pushkin. It is on the way, the performance you've been waiting for. Do not go anywhere. You're on your Feel Good Breakfast show. It's my feel-good breakfast show. You know what I love about you, Espresso family? The fact that you know nice things, because I told you not to go anywhere and you didn't, my babes. Therefore, I will reward you, okay? Here we go. We have got three superstars who have a song that dropped today. And here on Espresso, we're about exclusives. So everybody, please make some noise. It is Talk Music featuring Sykes as well as Pushkin. Time for Juluk.
Shout out to Talk. I think you're a little bit.
Dance until you sweat, my love. And these guys, they're going to make sure of that, not just here on Expresso, but all throughout South Africa. It's still a feel-good breakfast show, which is why we still have a full menu on the way. We're going to talk about because honestly and truly, where else would you rather be? We're going to take a short break, but we'll be back after this.
Thank you, Zanele. Well, it's just before 8 o'clock, so let's take a look at those national headlines. The MEC for Health in KwaZulu-Natal, Nomagugu Simelane, has assured unemployed doctors in the province that vacant positions will be advertised soon. Unemployed doctors recently protested at the department's head office in Pietermaritzburg. Simelane says positions will already be advertised this month, after which applications can be submitted. Doctors with or without scholarships may apply. She emphasized that doctors would not be appointed on the spot, but that an interview and selection process would take place. And the CEO of the new Newland Park Bayhead Rail Terminal in the port of Durban, Raj Balmakan, says the terminal will help to reduce road freight transport on the N3 between Johannesburg and Durban. President Cyril Ramaphosa opened the multipurpose terminal yesterday. Balmakan says this is an important development for trade in Africa. The rail terminal forms part of the largest freight transport system on the continent, where ship, rail and road freight can be distributed. The expectation is that this will give trade relations in Africa a huge boost. And we move to news beyond our own borders. The Minister of Agriculture in Mozambique has slapped a ban on the import of certain dog breeds considered dangerous. This after several dog attacks were reported in the country. The ban affects 26 dog breeds, including pit bulls, Rottweilers, German shepherds and Bourbons. Dog attacks are a common phenomenon in Mozambique. In the first half of 2023, some 9,000 people were bitten. Some attacks have even resulted in deaths. However, the measure excludes dogs used by public and private security companies and by disaster and rescue services. And aid groups in Gaza are demanding that the Israeli army tighten security procedures to protect their personnel. Seven workers of the NGO World Central Kitchen were killed in a drone attack on Monday. Israel apologized, saying it was a serious mistake. Countries whose citizens were killed in Monday's attack have condemned Israel. Meanwhile, US President Joe Biden has told Benjamin Netanyahu that US support for Israel will depend on steps being taken to address civilian harm and humanitarian suffering in Gaza. He said the strike and overall humanitarian situation in Gaza were unacceptable. And the Western Cape bids farewell to summer with a thriving tourism industry as Provincial Minister of Finance and Economic Opportunities, Marielle Wagner, reports significant growth. International arrivals at Cape Town International Airport from January to February exceeded 200,000, surpassing the 2019 figures and setting a five-year record. Visitor numbers at key attractions across the province have risen by 20% year on year, signalling positive economic impact through job creation. The UK, Germany, the USA, Netherlands and France top the overseas air market to Cape Town, and Namibia and Zimbabwe lead from the rest of Africa. Data from SA Tourism reveals that every 100 international visitors generate some 2.1 million rand in direct tourist spend. Well, that is where we leave those morning headlines. Here's a final look at your sport.
Thank you so much. So let's start with footballing news, and it is heating up in the running to the end of the Premier League season. Liverpool surging to the back of the Premier League table. That was with a gritty 3-1 victory over Sheffield United. So Darwin Núñez and Connor Bradley exchanged early goals before Alexis McAllister's sensational strike tilt the scales in Liverpool's favour. It's going to be one of his best, as Liverpool now sit 2 points clear of second place to Arsenal in their intense title race, with just 8 games remaining for each contender. And of course, Man City breathing hard. Then we stay with the Premier League, moving a little bit lower down the table. Another thrilling showdown. Chelsea orchestrating a remarkable 4-3 triumph over Manchester United. And they needed to take a late double, adding to his earlier penalty, including a nerve-wracking penalty conversion and that sensational winner in stoppage time. So the crushing defeat lighting their European ambitions after a roller coaster season under Mauricio Pochettino. An incredible one. Now let's turn to the tennis season and throw forward to the end of the season. In fact, the Women's Tennis Association has now confirmed that Saudi Arabia will host the WTA finals for the next 3 editions. That's from this year up until 2026. So the season ending tournament will take place in the capital city of Riyadh, with the first edition scheduled from the 2nd to the 9th of November this year. That deal comes after months of speculation and some criticism, but the WTA has expressed a lot of excitement about bringing a women's tournament of this magnitude to Saudi Arabia and certainly this part of the world. I think it really will make a difference. And the agreement also includes a significant increase in prize money, a record $15.25 million offered for this year-end tournament. Great step forward. Well, unfortunately, he's not putting his hand up this year. Rafa Nadal has withdrawn from the upcoming Monte Carlo Masters, citing that his body is just not ready for the competition. So this raises doubts now about his participation in his favourite major, the French Open. Nadal had initially been expected to make his comeback during the clay court swing leading up to the French Open. tournament. He's now won an incredible 14 times. However, his withdrawal from the Monte Carlo Masters certainly indicating that he is still not fully prepared to compete, let's say, at his highest level, which is probably higher than most. But sadly, he isn't going to be there. So that's where we leave our sport for now. Hopefully, the road's a little less competitive this morning. Let's get you to work safely.
Thanks, Graham. Let's start off with traffic in Midrand, Johannesburg. There's a stationary truck on the N1 northbound. It's before Allendale Road. The centre lane is closed, resulting in slow traffic and additional travel time. And if you're in Cape Town, there's been an accident on the N7 southbound. It's at the Wingfield interchange. The right lane is closed and it's causing heavy delays. Please exercise caution. That's your traffic. Let's take a final look at your weather. And it appears as if summer is bidding farewell to South Africa, with disruptive rainfall, flooding and severe cold predicted in three provinces. This as the SA Weather Service has issued a warning about a cutoff low and an intense surface high pressure system set to impact the Cape provinces from tomorrow until Monday. The public and small-scale farmers are urged to prepare for disruptive weather conditions, including heavy rainfall, flooding and icy temperatures in areas of the Western Cape, southern Namakwa and the Northern Cape, and the northern parts of the Eastern Cape. This follows prolonged heat waves and below-average rainfall in South Africa's interior. Moreover, coastal areas in the Western Cape should brace for damaging winds and waves. Well, that's your weather update. Here's a final look at your sunrise view. And Berenice from Langebaan is sharing our final one for this week. What a beautiful sunrise view. If you've captured one and would love to share it with us, our number is 063-408-8863. You can simply WhatsApp your picture to that number. Well, let's take a final look at your temperatures across the country.
Come on, Uppington, you can do it. Come on, the seasons have changed. Well, seasons are changing, and of course, it's a very special season for many. And we are going to get you prepared for your Eid celebrations. We've got some beautiful table setting ideas that are going to blow you away this morning from an incredible content creator as well. So stick around for that. And then, of course, we might do spring cleaning, yes, but some autumn and winter cleaning is okay. And if you're needing to refresh your space, we've got some brilliant cleaning tips that will just make life easier, and we all need a little bit of that.
The cooking and setting up the table, because doing the dishes and
Welcome back, you beauties. Thank you so much for keeping it locked in for the final hour as we head into the weekend. So we put it to you guys to start the conversation this morning that when you are hosting or your family is hosting, do you prefer to help with cooking the food, setting the table, or washing the dishes? Sometimes some of us are just relegated to washing the dishes, which is okay. But we ask you to send those voice notes, which you can keep coming. 063-408-8863 is the number to use. Or you could just drop us a note on any of our social platforms. So let's start right there.
Let's take a look. So our first comment came through from Nia Bane saying, good morning, fam. I will help with the cooking.
Yes, I know. Some people have to do that because they're the only ones who can cook, but this is where you learn those family secrets. Then Linda Torlo saying, good morning, Espresso team, definitely washing the dishes. I'm with you, Team Linda.
I will only offer to wash the dishes if there's a dishwasher. I'm not doing all
but
of
then
the
you better
dishes.
Stack it like
we're
a big family. Yeah, but then you must
we're
be like a Scandinavian engineer. Gary Oakup, I'm sure, loves packing a dishwasher. None of the above. But I will give the illusion that I'm hands-on when in reality I've just got my hands on a cocktail. It's still a job. It's still a role.
Tasneem also commenting saying the following, that definitely cooking the food. So quite a few cookers. I'm generally that person that sets the table.
Okay.
Only because my mom's got her thing going in the kitchen, and now at home, husband's got his thing going in the kitchen. And you feel like you're in their way.
Yeah.
So I just set the table.
I'm a side seat driver in the kitchen. I'm terrible. I think Lindsay's cursed to have someone like me, but it means I do all the cooking. And then she does the table setting and packs the dishwasher. Then I repack the dishwasher and everything's fine.
You repack it.
I don't think we're alone in that. But where do you fall in this equation? What job is yours? I love the fact that when you cook like this, this is where generational cooking kicks in. You learn the real family secrets, but you can keep those comments coming on our voice note line, or you can hit us up on any of the socials. When your family's doing the hosting, what role do you play?
Yes, Mzansi, welcome back. Your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And this morning, Mzansi, with obviously school holidays and many long weekends, this time of the year, most of us are entertaining and hosting extended family and friends. You know what I'm talking about, right? Now, we want to be proud of our homes and keep them sparkling clean. And the brand here to showcase how we can do just that is Plush. Now, they have a broad range of household and shoe care products and believe that less time cleaning means more time for you to do the things you love. I absolutely love this sentiment. So someone here to chat more about just that is their National Key Accounts Manager, Faiza Landers Latif, in the building. And I'm so grateful that you're here. How are you doing this morning?
I'm good, thanks. And yourself?
Fantastic. And excited that there's products out there that are allowing us to do exactly that, allow us more time to enjoy our time, because cleaning is that much easier, right?
Correct. Life is about living and spending time with your loved ones out there. It's not about doing these tedious tasks, you know, cleaning your house. So with Plush products, we make these tasks so quick and easy so that you can enjoy your valuable time with your loved ones.
I love that. You're already resonating with me. You're my kind of brand. This is about people. Well, listen, I've seen some incredible things of yourself personally. You're very active on social media. And I think many people are actually grateful for that, because you're sharing some valuable tips on products that people had no idea how to use as effectively as you're showcasing. And especially when it comes to one, I saw that Plush's wooden laminate cleaner. That was quite a good video, a lot of traction. But talk to me more about these products, why they are so unique and so valuable.
So besides the fact that our wooden laminate cleaner clean shines and protects your sealed wood and laminated floors, it's okay. So diverse. If you have wooden blinds in your house, you can actually use this product to clean your wooden blinds.
No way, is that
And great? As you know, as the wind comes through your windows, the smell of that cleaning products just lingers in the room for a long time.
It's like a 2-for-1, actually.
Correct. It's such a versatile product to be used.
I like that. Now, it obviously doesn't stop there, because the range is so extensive. I also see the pine gel.
It's
really something that's quite interesting. Can you talk to me more about its use? Because there's been some talk around this one.
Okay, so Plush's pine gel actually has the highest concentration of pine oil in the market.
Wow.
There are a lot of the other brands out there, their pine gel doesn't even contain pine oil whatsoever.
Oh, wow.
Our product also has no ammonia in it. So if you are using pine gel as a detergent, yes, it can be used as a laundry detergent. So if you have kids who play sports and they have grass stains on their rugby shorts or cricket pants, you have a hubby who works in the garage, a bit of grease on clothing, all you have to do is put a bit of pine gel on it and put it in your washing machine, because then there's no ammonia in it, you know. It's safe to use on any fabric. You can even use it on your couches. So, you know, sometimes we use a bleach or an all-purpose cream based cleaner in our bathrooms, and sometimes there's this white mark that it leaves behind. So that white mark is actually the ammonia, the sodium in the product. So because our product contains no ammonia, you'll have a clean, streak-free bathroom. You can use it on your wood, you can use it on your fabric couches, you can use it to clean your garage, your driveway. I'll give you an example. I had family over and I have whitewashed wooden floors in my dining area.
Ooh, that sounds quite overwhelming.
Someone spilled curry all over the floor.
Oh, so gosh.
All I did was take a little pine gel on a cloth, wiped it off, and there was absolutely no stain whatsoever.
So you don't stress anymore about these accidents. You know you've got a
cover. Lush products makes cleaning so easy at home.
Jeez, and the fact that you can use it for so many applications is actually mind-blowing. We need to pay more attention, clearly. We need to be more educated. But thank you for coming through. Maybe I can challenge you with this, because there's various different, let's say, textures and elements that are easier to clean and some are very hard. One thing that I know is a challenge is suede. We have it on certain couches, we have it on our shoes even, and we can't use water. What on earth, maybe from your side, can we use? Do you have anything? I know this might be quite a challenge for you, I'm putting you on the spot, but what would you recommend when it comes to trying to clean suede?
So,
that is a tough one.
Suede is our investment pieces, right? Whether it be couches, whether it be a jacket, whether it be a handbag, whether it be a pair of shoes. So the first product I would recommend is our plush protector. So this is basically a product that leaves a non-hardening film over your suede item that acts as a repellent against water, oil, grease, you know, anything like that. So we're protecting our product from the onset.
Brilliant, yeah.
And then we also have a product called Plush Suede Renew.
Oh, nice.
That renews, rejuvenates, nourishes, and revives any suede product, whether it be your jacket that you have for 5 years, your shoes that you only wear during a certain period of the year, your handbag that you very, you know, it has sentimental value to it.
Yeah.
And so the Suede Renew just revives the product completely.
That's brilliant. All right, so just going to add that one to the cart along with everything else you've just mentioned. Now, while I have you here, I think we've covered pretty much a lot when it comes to cleaning, but one of the big things is dishwashing, right? Do you have anything in this space? Well, I'm sure you do. What are the options when it comes to washing dishes? Because this is something that everybody has to, unfortunately,
tackle. On a daily basis.
On the daily, and I know you're making it easier. What do you have in this department?
Okay, so Plush's dishwashing liquid, besides the fact that it's an amazing quality, it's absolutely an affordable price.
Okay.
Right? We have an amazing foaming technique in it, and it even refoams. You know, sometimes you leave the water for an hour, so you forgot about something, and you
then
come
all
back,
the bubbles disappear.
All the bubbles disappear.
No, yeah.
All you have to do is put your hand in that basin, just give it a good shake, and it will actually refoam.
Okay.
Our products are also antibacterial, which means it kills 99.9% of germs.
Brilliant. I got a great idea. This is actually amazing for like camping and stuff. When you're sitting with one of those bowls, you don't have an actual sink. You can reuse that water with
the water all the time. Or leave something in overnight if you want to soak a very hard porridge bowl or something you had the night before. You can just because it will just automatically refoam with a bit of a shake the next day.
So maybe an essential to take with you on one of the trips, because I know everybody's planning their trips, whether it's camping or holidays. You can have an easy, clean, free holiday when you bring these products.
And then we're also launching a pouch. So, a little dishwashing liquid pouch, a refill pack.
Okay, yes.
So it'll have the same qualities as our 750ml bottle. So keep an eye out for that in the retail market soon.
I absolutely love that. And I'm sitting here thinking to myself, why have I been living under a rock, not knowing how incredible the range at Plush has to offer and how much it can do? So thank you so much for educating us and coming through with these bars of wisdom and gold. Now, Mzansi, you can also get in on this incredible action. We can make our lives that much easier, especially when it comes to cleaning. So listen up. They want to give a superb prize to fans of their brand and make the season even more enjoyable. So with Plush, here are all the details.
Stand a chance to win your share of 40,000 Rand worth of prizes with the exceptional Plush range of household cleaning, leather and shoe care products.
Oh yeah, now to enter, purchase any of the Plush ranges, take a photo of you using the products and WhatsApp the picture to 069-201-5794.
And with up to 30% off Plush products at major retailers this Easter, what are you waiting for? We love cleaning tips. I know you love cleaning tips.
And it's so handy and needy. But, you know, this morning with our Good Morning Post, we had quite an interesting one. You said you're more on the cooking side.
I'm definitely on the cooking
side. I am probably the person setting the table. But when your family is hosting, we asked you, which of those threes do you tend to do? And I feel like we need to find out from Zanele in Johannesburg.
This says a lot about the kind of person you are. Zanele, you gorgeous girl. I miss you, first of all. I miss you so much. Please come down to Cape Town again.
Can I guess?
Yeah.
Zanele, you definitely don't do the dishes.
No dishes.
No, never. Never, my Zoe. Guess again, my love.
No, with those beautiful nails, you should not do the dishes.
I think you wait.
Exactly. Zoe, you get me. This is the thing. But can I tell you? Can I give you guys the answer?
Go for it.
Okay. So, essentially, I am Beyonce in my family. Do you know what I mean? I'll sit and I'll look pretty. And I'm there to make sure that the atmosphere has like a good view, you know, when people are looking around. Ah, there's Anila is. You know what I mean? I'll take pictures with you. You know, we'll have a bit of fun on Instagram, on TikTok. So I provide entertainment. There we go.
There
I think that's
go.
What it is. You know what I mean? And every now and again, I'll take on the responsibility of, you know, the auntie with the key to that very important room. I'll take on that responsibility, family. Oh. So that's me.
You bring the vibe to any lunch.
The vibe.
Exactly. Zoe.
I love it. I just have a feeling you just wait for things to be brought to you, as Beyonce would.
I will eat the food. I'll be a taste tester. That's me, Graham. I fall into all of those categories. You feel me?
Oh, I love it. Well, you bring our vibe every morning, so we get that. We understand you are the energy. The atmosphere gets their view from you. I get it. I absolutely love it. Oh, Zanele, we
love
you. We're
going to
stop you.
And you guys bring it every morning.
Oh, no, stop. No, you. No, you. Stop it. Now, we will be connecting with Zanele again in just a moment. One more performance coming our way.
And definitely, we need to get your table setting ready for Eid. So stay tuned. Raisa is joining us again today, and she's brought a beautiful table setting that we want to unpack.
Oh, man. And then let's go back to that brioche bread with an almond filling. It's like, I love almond croissants. Mm-hmm. This is kind of like that, wrapped up with beautiful brioche bread. It looks exquisite. Oh man, it's our take on the almond croissant on the other side of this.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back. It is your feel-good breakfast show, and you're just in time because Eid al-Fitr is about celebrating the end of Ramadan with friends and family. And what better way than to do it with a delicious feast at a beautifully set table. Now, here to give us the ultimate Eid table inspiration is lifestyle content creator Raisa Albertus joining us again on your feel-good breakfast show. I love that we've got this beautiful, neutral table in front of us. So now my next question is, do you love neutrals or do you prefer pops of color?
I love neutrals, like for the base and then to just add pops of color. But I feel like neutral is elegant. And when you think of Eid, you think of like that elegance, the gold. So definitely the neutrals.
Definitely the neutrals with that pop of elegance. Tell me, your family Eid traditions, do you have any? How would a typical Eid look for your family?
So it's definitely the togetherness for me, waiting for the men to come from mosque while we're getting ready and doing the table setting so that when they come, everything's done. So for me, it's just having everybody together at the table, because you never get to do that in today's life. So literally the table is where you sit throughout the day creating memories. So for me, it's definitely the togetherness and waiting for my dad and my brother to come home from mosque and just having what you don't have every other day.
Yeah. And do you feel like your Eid traditions have perhaps evolved from when you were a little girl compared to how you are now?
It actually hasn't, and that's the great thing about it. I think we can all relate when we say that each family has like a headquarters.
Yes.
So it's just naturally that my parents' house is that house. So everyone's walking through that door and you're seeing everybody. So it's been like that from when I was young, like longest I can remember. Everyone just comes to one house. We feast, we celebrate, we make memories. And that's the nice thing about Eid is that it doesn't change.
No, and that's the beauty of it. So we want to keep that timeless look. Mm-hmm. Now let's unpack this beautiful table that you have curated for us today. When you set the table, what is your fundamental base that you focus on?
So I like to remember that when you're sitting at the table, you still have to be able to see the next person. So there's not much clutter, making sure that you're not like packing too many things so that when you're sitting next to somebody, you can still speak to them.
Yes.
However, like keeping the balance and still having it like looking beautiful and elegant and sophisticated. So for me, it's definitely keeping in mind that we as a family still have to sit here.
Yes, so, and you get to enjoy the time together. Let's look at each of these individual settings. We've got the beautiful plates.
Yes.
The side so plates.
And this is dishwasher friendly because ain't nobody got time to be doing dishes. So it's dishwasher friendly, which
and
is why we chose.
And microwave safe. We are here for it.
100%.
And look at these.
It's beautiful. So we went with the ivory colors so that whatever you put on, it will match.
Mm.
The placemat is nice because you can just wipe it off. You don't have to worry about stains. And then also the gold cutlery is by far my favorite. I think when you think of Eid and like a celebration, you think of gold.
Okay.
And it just looks expensive and luxurious and sophisticated. And then I also like to play on heights and dimensions. And that's when I use the glasses and the candle holders and the cake stands. That's where you really come in with the dimension and the play of the table.
And then your table's not so flat. And I'm a lover of candles. I mean, even if I'm eating dinner by myself, I will light a candle.
It just
I
creates
love having
that
a
ambience.
Candle. I need to show you these beautiful ones because you love gold, so I thought I should highlight these beautiful candles from Woolworths. They are absolutely exquisite and they're in this beautiful gold container.
I love it.
You can reuse it. Maybe pop some jewelry in there when the candle is melted. Absolutely beautiful. Now, when it comes to these beautiful items, what else do you do in order to prep your home for Eid?
So I really love flowers. Our fathers and our husbands are always getting us flowers, hint, hint. your neighbors down the street are always getting you flowers. So I like to really, it's nice that when it's neutral, you can pop any color flowers, it doesn't matter. So I really like that. And then also the rest of the home. So like putting on new throws, lamps to match the cutlery, curtains. I know for a fact that all moms are taking out their best curtains and throws that you've never seen before, and all of a sudden on Eid
it's out.
You're like, where did that come from?
The best for the best, because it really is that special. I love it. Now, you mentioned flowers. Do you have a favorite type of flower? Or are you open to most types of flowers?
I'm open to most types. I really like peonies. Is that what it's called?
Peonies? Yeah.
Yeah, I really like that. But I love all flowers. I feel like it just brings that fresh energy to a home.
Oh,
really love it.
Definitely.
I make sure my husband brings me flowers every Eid morning.
Oh,
like,
well,
it's non-negotiable.
That's how it should be. Well, I love this table you've put together for us, Raisa. You mentioned flowers. So we'll also give a whole couple of minutes to getting your flowers ready for your home. But now you can set the perfect table to celebrate Eid with your family and friends, and you get 20% off selected bedding items until the 7th of April. Shop this offer at Woolworths in-store, online, as well as on the Woolies app. T's and C's do apply, and also stay tuned as Raisa will be joining us in a bit to show how you can add color to your table with Woolworths flowers.
Oh, now let's fill this beautiful space with the smells of something absolutely scrumptious. If freshly baked pastries and bread is the way to win your heart, then we're about to sweep you off your feet. Today we are making an incredible almond croissant flavored brioche bread. Yes, combine those two things. This is pure buttery goodness that serves no other purpose than to make your heart and your taste buds swoon. And it is incredibly easy to make when we look at results that are this spectacular. So I've never in my life made a frangipane, okay? I feel like I'm going to say it wrong because it's just weird to say something for the first time. But that's that delicious almond paste that we've got there, which is the filling traditionally that would go in an almond croissant. Are you a fan of that flavor, frangipani? Are you a fan of that flavor profile?
I don't mind it. I absolutely don't. But I've never had the almond croissants. I've pretty much been on the plain side. So I'm quite excited to try this version on a brioche bun.
Let's win you over. Let's take you over to the dark side. And we're going to start with our frangipani, which is, yes, also a flower. But in this case, it is something that is so scrumptious. You're going to start creating dishes just to put this in, I have a feeling. So we are, for this, using, we promised buttery goodness. We are using our Springbok unsalted butter. So we will add a little bit of salt, but really simple to put together in terms of that filling. So we've got our softened Springbok butter here. We're going to add in a little bit of vanilla essence. We're going to add in some almond essence, and a little goes a long way, so don't overdo it. We've got a little bit of salt, as I said, because the butter isn't salted.
And there's just something about adding a little bit of salt whenever you bake to just bring the flavors together.
It really does combine everything, and then we're going to mix in just our regular almond flour. Mix that together into gooey, delicious awesomeness. And this I would make a lot because it is going to go. I mean, you could even put this in a fet cook. You could put it in anything. But when it comes to the brioche bread, it's the perfect sounding board. I think from a textural perspective, just definitely, amazing.
Definitely.
Okay, so you are on the most important job. Okay, start with first. We've got a little bit of syrup there. So you're going to, because we want the deliciousness to be seeped into our brioche bread. And we've cut really thick slices as a result. So you're just going to gently brush our syrup across.
I was going to pour the syrup.
I know, you were going to go all in. I would say do whatever your heart tells you to do.
Look, it like goes into the bread.
Oh, my word.
Like absorbs.
Oh, this is combining a lot of my favorite flavors here. So I absolutely love brioche bread. The texture of it, it's light. I quite like fruit in bread. I love fruitcake and things like that. I know it's a bit of an acquired taste for some, but this kind of brioche bread for me is first class. And now we're taking it a level higher. Very good.
There we go.
Your DIY skills coming to the fore. I love it.
In the kitchen.
And this is just going to seep in, and you're going to get that beautiful, beautiful gooey center, and of course the beautifully caramelized crunchy exterior as well. And now we can start layering on our frangipani.
So how generous are we with our topping?
I say we are ridiculously generous.
Okay.
I feel like that's just the kind of people we are, Zoe. Okay? In this espresso kitchen, we are all about love and filling hearts and filling bellies. That looks great.
That looks great. We'll just spread it out.
And it's your kitchen. Girl, you can do whatever you want, okay? Don't let that Robbie push you to the back to dishwashing duties,
okay? Oh, no, trust me. I prefer his cooking to my own.
Oh, really?
So I'm happy. And you know what? I actually cheat because he's such a neat cooker that literally it's just the plates we're eating off that I end up cleaning. Love doing dishes when he cooks.
He is well-trained in that space, but it does make a big difference.
I use every spoon in the cupboard when I cook.
Oh, no, I'm terrible, and I get chastised for it. But I'm like, but you've got to get things dirty to cook, man, and that's how I teach my kids, okay? Just a couple of pointers here. When working with butter, if you're going to be baking or cooking with it, actually, for that matter, keep it at room temperature before you use it. It makes it so much easier to work with. Obviously, we just really heated our butter a little bit to make it that much easier to mix in. But once it's melted, it's so easy to work with. And then once our final layer of our frangipani has gone on, we're just going to add our toasted almonds. You pop this into the oven 180 degrees for about 5 minutes. Just keep an eye on it. You want a little bit of crispy crust there, but you don't want to push it too far. And then you're going to get the beautiful balance of the texture, the crunchiness and the gooiness on the inside, and a flavor that is unmatched. Well done,
Zoe. Here we go. That was quite quick and easy.
And it's spectacular when you look at that end result. That is absolute magic. You deserve a slice of love. Say it to yourself in a mirror somewhere and make this almond croissant flavored brioche bread this weekend just for yourself. Keep it all for you. It is an absolute winner, and you can get the full recipe at expressoshow.com. Wow. In the oven you go.
I'd love another one, please, Mommy. With bacio and lots of jam.
Another sandwich.
Clover Batro. Spread the dairy goodness.
Made with love by Clover.
Ah, man, where does the time go when you're having so much fun? It's crazy that we're in the last 30 minutes of the show, but we're going to be finishing off on a high. We are going to be not only getting into flowers for Eid, but we're also going to be getting into a random word song challenge. Halls is in the building, and my friend, it is about to be a refreshing time indeed. We're going to take a short break and get ready for that, but you make sure that you do not go anywhere. We'll be back on the other side of this.
Oh, welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Espresso on S3, and there's nothing like joyful blooms during a special occasion. And here to show us how we can elevate our Eid tables with the beauty of fresh flowers is lifestyle and content creator Raisa. She hasn't left us, and I absolutely love this. Now, I asked you this question earlier. How can we bring colour onto our Eid table? And you said flowers.
Yes, and you can see the difference. It's honestly made such a difference. And it's nice that your base was neutral because now everything matches.
Yes, and I mean, look how you can use flowers on the side of your 100%. Plate. We've got some white roses here, so you can just complete the setup by inserting the little white rose and your setting's complete.
Perfect.
Oh, you need a white rose too. Let's get you one. Oh,
thank you.
Now, I love that we get to use fresh flowers on our table. When I think flowers, I just think in a vase, but of course, I'm hoping you're going to show me there's many ways to be creative with these fresh, beautiful flowers.
So like I said, keeping in mind that you need to still be able to speak to the person opposite you. So imagine this was like in front of you, like keeping like... So I like to use items that are not meant for flowers, so like a bowl, cutting the stems off and then placing it in here, and look at that.
It's beautiful.
It's not in the way. It doesn't look cluttered. Do you want to put this one on that side?
I will put that on this side. Let's put it here so that the camera can see it over there.
And it's nice. It's close to you.
And it adds that pop of colour. Mm-hmm. It adds that softness 100%. To your table and that freshness, which we like. Now, we've got beautiful arrangements here. We've used some of the flowers on the side of our plate. That is a great way to use it. You can also... Let's talk about arrangements. Is that something you like to do with your fresh flowers when you buy it, to make it a bit of a unique arrangement?
I think with Hoolies, they really have it down to the T, so you don't have to do much. But like, for example, cutting a few and adding it here and there just to tie everything in together. That's what I really love to do. But these bunches as is perfect, but just here and there I'll cut a few and then put it on the table just to tie everything in together.
I love this. Everything looks spectacular. We've got beautiful fresh roses here. We've got them in the beautiful white. Also, do you know the name of these flowers? I never know the name.
No.
I should know the name, but they are also absolutely incredible. They come in various colors.
They do.
And we also, I love that we're playing with all these different tones and bringing it all together. Another flower that I love, and I'm pretty sure you would also add it to your table, is eucalyptus.
Yes, I love it. I even put that in the shower. So when people go in the bathroom, it's like just a different energy. So everything ties together. Your whole entire house is full of flowers and it just screams Eid.
Yes, it does. Now we've got the table sorted. You will put flowers throughout the house. Where would you put a beautiful arrangement like this?
Maybe on your actual like countertop, or maybe next to your couch where you had the beautiful throws. Wherever, really. I don't think flowers has any rules.
No, I don't think so either. I love that we get to be creative and you really get to express yourself. Raisa, thank you for joining us, showing us this beautiful Eid table setting, going with the neutral tones, but bringing the pops of color through flowers, and also sticking to your mantra of not having anything on the table that can become an obstacle to chat to your guests.
Yes.
So using everyday household items and simply putting the roses in here, and you've got a beautiful bowl of flowers on the table. So absolutely incredible. And you can brighten up your Eid table setting with Woolies fresh flowers. You can shop everything you need for your Eid feast at Woolworths. It's available in-store, online, as well as on the Woolies app. Plus, we've got a 2,000 Rand Woolies gift card to give away. Now, you can find the Woolies competition post on Expresso's Facebook, X, or Instagram pages, and tell us, what are your favorite flowers to include on your Eid table? Don't forget to include that hashtag Woolies Eid. The competition will close this coming Sunday, the 7th of April at midnight. There are T's and C's, and those can be found on our website, expressoshow.com.
It's winning all around here on Expresso. And honestly, it is all about us and just giving you all the love in putting you in the position to win. So today, of course, we all know that, friends, sometimes life gets a little bit overwhelming, yeah? And you need to take a second just to refresh, refocus, and just breathe. Am I right, guys? Is that correct?
Yeah.
Lebo the great, he breathed even. You're right. Yes. Are you breathing because you're nervous, Lebo?
No, I'm not nervous.
Oh, you're not? Oh, sorry. Are any of you nervous?
No.
Just
breathing.
Oh, just breathing. I love it. Okay, Expresso family, this is what is going to be happening, right? We are going to be doing the random word song challenge. We're giving these gents a word each. They got to come together and they got to give us a song. So, guys, I have these words here in the hat. And you need to choose one randomly. Don't take the holes inside, please.
Okay.
I'm begging you. Because holes is here to refresh and refocus. We're going to have one now.
Okay,
word number one. Let's hear, Lebo, what's your word? Open it for us, please. Mm-hmm. You can take so long there, Sykes. Go ahead.
Dance.
Ooh, that's a nice one. Sykes, what's yours?
Yeah.
My one.
It is.
Mm-hmm.
While listening properly.
Refresh.
Come on. Pushkin, you can't choose which one you want. You need to randomly take between winner.
I randomly took.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. What is it?
Courage.
Courage, my brother, come on. You can do it. I believe in, yes,
right,
exactly.
Right,
okay,
right.
So Halls is in the building, all in the name of us having this fun time. Like we said, we are refreshing, we are refocusing, and we are breathing. So, gents, you are going to be having a little bit of time to put this together, ne?
Okay.
So just to give you some superpowers, yabo, I'm going to give you a Halls each. Just because we can, okay?
Thank you.
So here we go. You can take one and pass on.
Okay.
There we go.
Okay, Kareji.
Kareji. Done.
Yes. Express.
It's going to be a hectic challenge, but you guys, I believe in you. You can do this, ne?
Hey, sure.
You can do it.
Hey, where's Zanele? Hey,
can I have one, please?
Can you give me like a pack of this?
A pack of this. I might so be much. Able to. Maybe I know some friends in high places at halls.
Yeah. I hope you are smart enough to have time.
But we do love halls. So let's pop one in, and then we need a unison. Ne? Yes, we are highing. Okay, everybody ready? Yes. Yo, highball. Okay.
King of my daughter.
Okay, in three, two, one. Hi, Pushpin. Expresso family, I need you to not go anywhere. We're about to do this with Halls, as well as Live with the Great, Sykes, and Pushkin. It is the Random Word Song Challenge, and we are going to be seeing just how creative these guys can get. They got the words, it's dance, it's courage, and what's yours there, Sykes?
Refresh.
That's right. It's refresh, honey. We've got three words, three guys, one song. It's coming up right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. You make sure you don't go anywhere.
Danko.
Brought to you by Halls and the power of menthol. Refresh, refocus, Halls. Breathe for it. Ungapheli umoya.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Oh, if you felt like you've missed out on any of the action this morning, fear not, because you have a chance. You have your chance to grab your tickets right now and play Powerball for a remarkable 131 million rand jackpot this Friday. You do not want to miss out on your chance to win big. I think we've gone bigger than this actually since we've been working with them, and you could become Mzansi's next multi-millionaire.
Oh, listen, I envy the person to walk away with that jackpot, and it could be you, but you need to buy your tickets, and you can do so today in store on the nationallottery.co.za website. You can buy your ticket on their mobile app or through your cell phone banking app, or by dialing *120*7529# for USSD.
I love the fact this is the one competition we can actually enter. You know, we can never enter these competitions, but we're allowed to do this, and we're going to keep those details up on our social media pages, so you've got no excuse. You can go and check them out at your leisure, but don't wait too long. That life-changing, potential 131 million rand Powerball jackpot is there for you, but you've got to play, and play now. Good luck.
Oh, can you just imagine that? 131 million rand in your bank account.
I'm going on to the app straight after this. And it's great if you do it through the banking app. They update you, they send you your tickets, and they let you know if money's going back. I won 15 rand last week. 131 is coming to me this week. We're going to have a lot of fun. Of course, being a Friday, being the foot of the weekend, we're going to get into it with a bit of a Friday dance and have a whole lot more fun with our crew in Johannesburg as well.
Yes, it's true. Fun is on the way. Why? Because we are still with our guests this morning. Also, Graham used a word, life-changing. The three guys that were with here, Lebo the Great, Sykes, and Pushkin, when you listen to their music, friend, it is life-changing indeed, which is why Balls is in the building, and they wanted to play a random word song challenge. We gave these gents three words. They picked it out of a hat randomly. And Lebo the Great, yours was?
Dance.
Yours was Sykes?
Refresh.
Yours was Pushkin?
Courage.
Courage, yebo. So, we have asked them to put together a song for us. And everybody, I'm going to ask you, let's give them a round of applause already. We're encouraging
yebo,
them.
Yebo, 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 yeah. Yeah.
We're giving them the courage, you know? And we are refreshing and refocusing with Halls, all in the name of, in fact, my friend, breathing. So, gents, are you ready for us?
Yeah.
Yo, 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 here we go. Okay. You can take it away.
Okay.
I'll count you down. Three, two, one. Let's go.
Fire dancer. Is our boy refresh? Belly courage. Belly courage.
I know.
Fire dancer. When I. Is our boy refresh? When I. Belly
Challenge. My goodness. Okay, guys. That was incredible. Guys, what do you give yourselves out of 10 for
10.
That?
10.
Oh, sorry. Sykes? yeah.
8.
8. All right. What about you, Pushkin?
Me, I'm going to give myself 9.
9. I like it.
For now.
For now. Okay. Not for... Are you guys going to go back to the studio and,
yeah.
You
know?
Yeah, we're going to cook it.
And cook it together.
Submit
I love
it to Halls.
I love it. Okay. Especially because you guys had to do this in 2 seconds. Like, what was the mandate? How did you guys get to that, what you just got to now?
Hey. It's the chemistry.
It's the chemistry.
It's the chemistry and it's the holes behind it.
Yeah.
The ha.
The ha.
It's the ha.
I love it. So first and foremost, I want to just say you guys absolutely killed it.
Thank you.
You killed it. So Pushkin, when you weren't even like focusing earlier on, did the holes help you to focus? Okay, let's do the song one more time. Let's do that. Ne? Can you guys? How do you guys remember it? Here we go.
Yeah. Yay.
Yay! Everybody, give them a round of applause again. Oh my goodness. A song literally made up in 5 minutes. This is why I said they're taking over the music industry, my lovely. And shout out to Halls helping us refresh, refocus, and just breathe. For now, though, we are going to be taking a nice breather with the Friday dance as we go on into the weekend. Cape Town showing us how it's done. Guys, are you going to be breaking it down?
No, thankfully, we brought in the pros to do it. Well, they are destined for very big things. The Limerie Academy of Dance, there is a reason why they came into our radar and we had to bring them into studio officially for our Friday dance. Yes, they look awesome. They've got the fire in their eyes. And that's largely because of the mentorship of Limerie herself. Welcome to the show. So I'm going to fill you in. She is absolutely terrified to be on TV, which is crazy for me because dancers love the limelight, okay? But there is something really special going on. There is a reason why this has manifested this moment for you, and you've been manifesting quite a few big moments with your Dance Academy. Just give us a bit of background. Who are these young ladies and what are you guys all about?
Okay, so this is Team Ravage, and yeah, this is one of our competition teams. They are actually getting ready for traveling to Croatia.
Oh, wow.
In the 18th of May for the World Dance Masters. We are very excited. They've been working really hard. And yeah, I'm super proud of them.
We can feel it. And that, when I joke about the fire in the eyes, there is something about this feeling. I've been working with amazing dancers. I'm married to dancers because I just love the art form so much. But there is something so awesome about seeing the athleticism, the level that dance is at right now. When you talk about preparing for an international showpiece like this, what goes into that preparation? How hard are these ladies working?
A lot of work goes in. Lots of hours, lots of tears, lots of fighting. I mean, some of these dancers, they come to class 15 hours a week.
Sure.
What's the minimum? I think 3-4 hours. Yeah.
Got to do it, man.
But most of them are 10 plus hours a week at the studio. So, yeah.
It becomes a family. So thank you for being that. I can see the marks that dance leaves. Yes, the awards are great and the TV time is great, but it's that tribe, that culture that you get to plug into.
We are definitely a family.
Oh, I love it. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
All the best of luck. As we say, break a leg. We're going to give them a chance now to do what they do best. It's the Limerie Academy of Dance taking us out with our Friday dance. You can get off camera now. Go, girl.
I'ma be. I'ma be rocking over that bass trap. I'ma be chilling with my mother monkey crew. I'ma be making all the deals you wanna do. I'ma be up in the A-list flicks, doing one-handed flips, and I'ma be sipping no trickers. I'ma be shaking my head. You gon' be licking your lips. I'ma be taking them pics, looking all fly and shit. I'ma be the flyest chick. I'ma be spreading my wings. I'ma be doing my thing. Okay. I'ma swing it this way. I'ma swing it that way. It's Becky Fergie. I'ma be here to stay. The 21st century till infinity.
Popping that bubbly, cooling and living that good life. Oh, let's make this last forever. Party and we'll chill together. On and 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 on.
I'ma be rocking like this. What? Young one talk. What? Why don't you put it on the blog? Rocking like this is my job. We can't help that we popular, and all these folks wanna flock to us. Come to a show and just rock with us. A million plus with binoculars.
Fire in the eyes. Yay, bye, Zoe. We love you guys. We will see you bright and early on Monday. To Joshua and the ladies, thank you so much. The Limerie Academy of Dance heading off to Croatia to go and represent SA. All the best of luck. As we said, break a leg, just not before you get there. Take a bow, please. You're incredibly talented young superstars.
They were super duper stars. Thank you for joining us today. Of course, all of those recipes we made today is available on our website, expressoshow.com. Have a wonderful weekend.
Adios.
I'd love another one, please, Mommy. With Bacho and lots of Jack.
Another sandwich.
Clover Batro. Spread the dairy goodness.
Made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.